Good. I know it's a nervous laugh, okay, because it's been a week, okay? It has been a week. It's halfway there. We are almost done. It's the midweek. It's the downhill to the weekend, and it's all feel good, baby. Thank you so much for joining us. Good morning. Good morning, my brother.
Good
How
morning,
are you?
Man, I'm good, and you? Welcome back.
I'm good,
can
man.
Can you refresh?
Hey, look at the light of these eyes. How can you not wake up and be excited? No, we are excited because it's a Wednesday, which means the food takes over. And I think Clem has got something up his sleepy sleeve this morning. Mm. He might even be in his pajamas today. I don't know.
I'm here for it, man. I'm here for it. Because obviously we are focusing on something that some of us get to enjoy. Some of us have no idea what it even means. But we're talking about breakfast in bed. Now, it's safe to say that there are no limits here when it comes to what Chef Clem's going to come up with. But I don't know from you, G, like breakfast in bed, is that something you are familiar with?
I think I had it once.
In the distant
yeah,
past,
I remember it once because I'd fallen asleep with some food in the bed. And when I woke up, there was a half a piece of toast. And in our world, breakfast in bed is a bit of a rarity. Let's be honest. Yeah, we're generally the first people up.
Yeah.
Not to say I'll make myself breakfast in bed.
It would actually legitimately require someone to probably make the food like the night before just to be ready for us by the time we wake up.
It's called meal prep, guys. It's called meal prep. But maybe you have got something that's a lot more cozy, sweet, lovable, whatever it is. Maybe it's your kids
making the
best ever breakfast in bed. We want to hear from you because today it's about staying in bed. You've got an excuse. Unfortunately, Zoe had to get out of bed to tell you this, but she'll be getting back into bed in just a moment. Morning, Zoe.
Morning. Good morning. Yes, we've got a workout for you that you can do from the comfort of your own bed. But for now, we want to know all about the breakfast in bed treats you've had. And in fact, this morning, we're asking you, what's the craziest thing you've had for breakfast in bed? We won't judge you, so please send us a voice note. Our number is 063-408-8863. And of course, we do want to make sure that you share those crazy breakfast in bed things. For me personally, it is more of a weekend treat, and I definitely want a nice orange juice with it or a cup of coffee. But let us know. We would love to hear what you enjoy for breakfast in bed on your Feel Good Breakfast Show.
And hey, for some of you that do not get anything in bed, don't worry, I'm going to deliver you the news right now on official duty so you can relax and pay attention. Starting off with the national news headlines, the unions representing the majority of SA's public sector workers have confirmed that they have accepted the government's revised 7.5% wage increase for the next 2 years. Now, the government initially offered 4.7%, but upped its offer to prevent protracted wage negotiations and a prolonged strike. Now, the national manager of the Public Servants Association, Claude Nyker, said most of the unions represented had taken that offer to their constituencies and their members for general approval. Well, sticking to national headlines, the High Court in Cape Town has ordered that the alleged parliament arsonist Zandile Mafe be sent for psychiatric evaluation at Fort England Hospital in the Eastern Cape. Now, he will be admitted to the facility for 30 days to assess his state of mental health at the time he allegedly committed the crime. Now, after the evaluation, Mafe will be moved to Paulsmoor Correctional Centre until his next court appearance on the 8th of May. Now, the accused faces several charges, including arson, terrorism, as well as theft. Well, from our national news headlines, we head over to international news. Now, Egypt will soon allow Iranians traveling with tour groups to obtain visas on arrival in the south of its Sinai Peninsula with a view to extending access to other parts of the country, and this being said by Egyptian tourism ministry's officials. Now, it comes as some Middle Eastern countries, including Egypt, are taking steps to ease regional tensions. Now, Egypt's Sunni Muslim Arab ally Saudi Arabia, as well as Shiite Muslim Iran, announced this month that they were and would restore diplomatic relations. Now, carrying on with international news, a prominent Afghan campaigner for female education has been arrested by the Taliban. Now, Matiullah Wessa, 30 years old, has spent years traveling across Afghanistan trying to improve access to education for all children. Now, the Taliban didn't say why Wessa is in custody, and his arrest follows the detention of a number of other activists who have been campaigning for women's education. Now, Wessa is one of the most prominent education activists in Afghanistan, and via his charity, Penpath, has been campaigning for girls' rights to study since the Taliban banned female education in 2021. Well, carrying on with the headlines, Dr. Shleni Ndume, an ophthalmologist in Namibia, born and bred there in the small mining town of Tsumeb, is known in her home country as a miracle doctor. Now, her achievements have been just amazing. Working with the humanitarian organization SEE International, she's helped perform sight-restoring surgeries to some 38,000 people at no cost since 1997. Now, she and her team help eradicate preventable blindness in Namibia and also in neighboring countries. Now, as an ophthalmologist, she's internationally renowned. In the past, she scooped two major accolades, the Lions Club International Humanitarian Award and the Forbes Woman Africa Social Impact Award. Now, of late, she was also recognized in Forbes Africa's The 50 Over 50 list of Africa's powerhouses. And of these accolades, she simply said, and quotes, "It was very humbling." She also added that, "My work's one of passion. No money in this world can pay for the happiness of someone who was once blind." Now, Dr. Ndume, we at Expresso salute you and wish you all the luck in the world. For now, though, that's all I have for you when it comes to the news headlines. But let's touch on the sport and see what's happening in the latest. And here's G with it all.
Thank you so much. Well, I didn't want to say any luck was needed with this one, but perhaps just a little bit. South Africa have now secured a place at next year's Africa Cup of Nations. We are going to AFCON, and that's courtesy of a 2-1 away win over Liberia. So Bafana, they guaranteed a top two finish in their Group K alongside the already qualified Morocco, thanks to goals from Zakhele Lepasa and Mitlali Mayambela. So Bafana held their nerve to get the victory and secure their place at the Nations Cup for the first time since 2019 in Egypt. Then on to cricketing news. The West Indies claimed a 7-run win in that third and final T20 to win the three-match series 2-1 and maintain their record of having never lost a T20 series here in South Africa. So just a few days on from their record run, Chase the Proteas won the toss and decided to chase yet again, which you can understand. The visitors were scoring at a pretty good pace, but regular wickets meant they found themselves 161 for 8 with just 4 overs left. Romario Shepherd, 44 not out, and Alzari Joseph, 14 not out, putting on 59 for that ninth wicket, including hitting the last over for 26 to help their side post 220 for 8. In response, Reeza Hendricks was the mainstay for the hosts, really has found some form, scoring 83. And Joseph, though, starred with the ball as well, taking 5 for 40 as the Windies held on for a memorable win. Then on to rugby news. The Blitzbox were handed a pretty tough draw for the prestigious Hong Kong Seven series taking place this coming weekend. So the event, the 8th of 11 in this year's calendar, sees South Africa contest Pool D alongside New Zealand, Ireland and Kenya, all teams that have beaten the Blitzbox at some point this season. Now, finishing in the top two of the pool means the Blitzbox will play one of the top two finishers from Pool A, made up of Canada, Samoa, Fiji and Argentina, all pretty strong. The Hong Kong Seven starts this coming Friday, and South Africa will play against Ireland up at 9:04 a.m. in the morning SA time. So set your alarm now. Then on to athletics. The International Olympic Committee has recommended that Russian and Belarusian athletes be allowed to compete under a neutral flag, but they've yet to make a decision on Paris for 2024. So this recommendation only extends to individual athletes and not teams. The IOC's executive board has also told international federations and event organizers that athletes and support personnel who actively support the war in Ukraine or who are contracted to the military should not be permitted to compete. It's going to take a lot of working out, I have a feeling, this one. Hopefully we can unlock it ahead of the Olympics, but we'll watch that space. Right now, though, let's get set for the weather ahead, bring you some weather news, some areas heavily affected at the moment, and then get into some of your sunrise views.
Thank you, Graham. And we start off with some news of flooding in Port St. John's that has caused havoc. President Cyril Ramaphosa has assured residents there that have been affected by the floods that the contractor will commence building them temporary structures today. Ramaphosa visited the Eastern Cape town after recent floods left thousands of households destitute and 3 people lost their lives on Friday. The floods disrupted critical infrastructure and services to water and electricity supply services, teaching and learning, as well as roads and bridges. the president said local traditional leaders had identified land where the structures would be built. The government has activated a special intergovernmental committee on disaster management to provide support and relief to the affected communities. Teams comprising national, provincial and local spheres of government have been assessing the damage and providing emergency support in the form of shelter, food, blankets and essentials. Well, that is your news update for now. Let's bring it to your sunrise views. Kicking us off this morning is JP from Robertson, enjoying another view from his balcony while looking at the sky. Just look at the colours change on that photo. Absolutely beautiful. Then Shiara from Benoni is also enjoying a blissful view on her balcony overlooking the fields of green grass and blue skies. Then Nancy Govender shared this photo of the violet tones in the sky, and that is from her home in Umkomaas. And last up, we have Frederick from Somerset West who shared this photo. Look at those beautiful colours in the sky with the mountain in the background. It's absolutely beautiful. Well, if you have a sunrise view to share with us, our number is 063-408-8863. Let's get into today's temperatures, starting off in Polokwane. Your low is 14, your high 28. Mbombela, 18 with a high of 34. If you're in Pretoria, a low of 14 and a high of 26 can be expected. Johannesburg, 14, 24. Mahikeng, 13, 27. Klerksdorp, 14, 27. Kimberley, 7 with a high of 29. Bloemfontein, 6 with a high of 25. Richards Bay, 19, reaching a high of 29. Pietermaritzburg, 16, 26. Durban, 20 with a high of 25. If you're in Mthatha, 12 your low, 24 your high for today. East London, 13, 23, Craddock, 7, 25, Kabega, 14 with a high of 22 and some windy conditions. If you're in George, rain can be expected, 12 your low, 18 your high, Cape Town, 14, 19, Worcester, 7, 22. If you're in Sutherland, 3 is your low, 19 your high, and Upington, a low of 11 with a high of 29 degrees Celsius. Well, that's where we leave your weather for now. We'll have another update shortly after 7.
Thank you so much, Zoe. Yes, the weather's looking good this week, but something that's looking even better is this show. Now, we're talking about breakfast in bed, and of course, the culinary heartland bling! Ching, ching, ching! Yes, it's back, but we've got something even more special. Someone from the Crush Show is about to deliver something special, a content creator, inspiring presenter too. So, Mini, introducing you to the world, why don't you take us to an ad break? I know I'm putting you on the spot, but give it a try.
All right. Thank you so much for joining us. My name is Minnie, and we are still waking you up with the bang. We're going to go for an ad break. When we come back, it's Swim of Espresso.
What?
It's my feel good breakfast show.
Good morning, South Africa. My name's Clem Pedro. It's Wednesday.
It is.
You heard the jingle, which means it's time for the Culinary Hotline Bling!
Yes, man. Shout it from the rooftops, from the mountaintops, from bed.
From the bed, exactly. Today's theme is about everything breakfast in bed. We asked you last week what your ultimate breakfast is when you're being served breakfast in bed, and also when you're making breakfast in bed. You've given us some amazing suggestions this morning, but it doesn't end there. We still want to hear from you. Keep on sending your voice notes through, letting us know about your ultimate breakfast in bed dish. Send that. Send your message to the WhatsApp line at 063-408-8863. That number, by the way, is actually G's personal WhatsApp number. You should send a voice note through to him, address it to him. He's all about breakfast in bed. You are, right?
Yeah, send videos, pictures. I am. I'm all about that. Buddy, you got to marry yourself a gorgeous foodie if you want breakfast in bed every day, okay? And between the two of you, I'm sure you get breakfast in bed every day, literally, to each other. Say that, please, lines. Say that.
And we're both chefs, which is amazing. So we're both chefs, so we're both like treating each other to breakfast in bed. We have got a serious tradition around it. Do you?
We don't. So on special occasions, I'll help the kids make breakfast in bed for mom or vice versa, that kind of thing. But, you know, breakfast TV land, unfortunately, we are denied breakfast in bed. But that being said, I get breakfast cooked for me by some of the best chefs in the country every single morning. So it's okay.
It's okay.
It's okay.
And we have a bed in studio today, so you can have breakfast in bed.
Exactly.
Yes. So we've actually got a comment from last week on social media. It's like immediately, we asked the question, we were like, breakfast in bed, what do you want?
Okay.
People came through.
Let's see.
Let's see what they say.
Booyah.
Who's that guy?
Freddie Alfred. Whoa, what are you eating? That looks amazing. Freddie saying, English breakfast, thank you. Sylvia, English breakfast. Joseline van Buren saying, English breakfast, please. Lots and lots of yummy faces. I'm picking up a particular trend. Let's see if there are any more.
It is.
I guarantee you it's going to be more of the same. Ruth Wallow, an English breakfast.
I love it.
I'm so down for that.
We're going full English this morning.
And there is something special about saying that, you know, it's a special time of your life when you can sit down generally on a Sunday or maybe on a Saturday when you've got the extra chill time. You say, nah, full English, thanks.
Full English,
crispy bacon, full English.
Okay, let's talk about what is on the dish when it comes to full English.
What makes it English?
We got bangers.
There we go.
We got bacon.
There we go.
We got beans.
There we go.
We got black pudding.
Yes,
we got the roasted tomato. We've got the toast and we got the fried egg.
You passed the test.
The black pudding. Let's get started. Okay,
where do we begin?
For the beans, right?
This is just too small. We're not going to be able to cook anything.
That's ridiculous. That's for your beans, by the way, so that's fine. Okay, we've got some shallots in the pot, a little bit of oil in there. We've got some beans going in. Also, I was meant to have Ryle in the kitchen with me, but Mance taken to the theme really well.
Yeah.
And if we actually try and find him in the studio, I'm pretty sure we'll find him in bed.
Uh-huh. Oh, there we go.
Look at him.
Morning, love.
At him.
You catch another 15. Just press snooze.
You chill there, my boy. Okay. Beans go in with the shallots, a little bit of red chili. This is totally just up to you, but it does add a nice little warmth to the dish.
I love chili in a breakfast. Like, for me, the yolk goes so well with a chili flavor profile.
Absolutely.
There's something about that works. So this even more so, because the beans and the yolk have a special relationship as well, I think.
That's true.
In the mix,
they kind of come together and make a sauce on their own. Right, so super simple. My pan's smoking, so what you want to do actually is, I like starting my bacon off in a cold pan.
Okay.
I like rendering the fat out of the bacon. When the pan's too hot, it actually seals the bacon. That's why we seal steak. So what am I doing in the background? I'm just cooling my pan slightly.
Yeah.
Okay, cool. So bacon goes down.
Just adding drama, dude. Yeah.
Give it some space there. And you can, by all means, Woolies have the most amazing smoked duck rashers.
Oh, wow.
That's delicious.
There are other options, yeah.
There are. And instead of going for normal pork bangers, they've got beef, they've got lamb, they've got duck, they've got veggie, they've got fish, they've got it all. So you can play around with the variations and make it your own. Okay, that's going to do its thing. Another tip that I have to help the water the fat release out of the bacon and to slowly steam the bangers as they fry.
Tiny touch. Just
Wow. Tiny touch. That's all you need. So let that do. Sink, turn the heat down. You don't need too much of a high heat. If your heat is too high, you know what happens? Your banger's going bang.
They're going to bang and go pshit.
And that's why they name bangers, by the way. They used to just
in bang the, open
pan,
like
in the
that.
Pan apart. So you want to keep it out.
This, guys, this is one of those hacks. Actually, you haven't given this to us before, this notion of adding a little bit of water just to let more of that cook through.
Absolutely.
Let more of that fat render. I love it. Okay, what's next?
I need you to slice up a tomato. I need you to cut it in half. Part of the English breakfast is a nice chunky grilled tomato.
Okay, for
I've got
sure.
the mushies. I've got the black pudding. So I'm going to add the black pudding to the pan. Mushy's super simple. Yes, for English breakfast, you do end up using quite a few pans because a lot going on there, but it's well worth it.
Yeah.
While G's busy with the tomatoes, all you're gonna do is black pudding. Don't be scared. It's okay. Yes, it is made
from out of stuff.
But it's so flavorful. It crisps up beautifully and it adds so much flavor. This is what makes it a proper English.
And I did, look, the first time I was in the UK proper meeting my English family and kind of getting stuck, and you know that I had a particular milk stout drink with my breakfast, with my black pudding, everything just to seal
you
the
have
deal.
To.
Yeah,
you
no,
have
it's
to.
Only because everyone else was, and I felt out and I found out. I was like, can I have an orange juice? And they were like, whatever. Bring the matter pint.
I get that from you. Okay, back to our beans. The beans are looking amazing. Now, the tomato sauce you're getting beans is quite sweet.
I've gone very chunky, eh?
Hey, that's how we like it. Tomatoes, like this thick, witness the thickness, and that's how you want it.
I
too
love
thin,
it.
It's gonna just fall apart in the pan.
Yeah.
Okay, so we're gonna give it a slice. I think we should just check on Raul real quick. Man's out.
Oh, he's dreaming.
Man's out.
He's dreaming of the breakfast right now, or one of us, judging by the smile. Oh, he's definitely dreaming about you, man.
Oh, look at him. Okay.
And
let's
I think
go.
The tomato, you need almost that acidity or something just to cut through because there's a lot of fat.
There's a lot of fat. Exactly, and I feel like the tomato is essential to this dish.
Yeah, just
so
to
like
balance.
I said, we've got that sweetness of the beans, right?
Lovely.
Sherry vinegar.
Okay.
So it's a bit of acid just to cut through that. That's all you need, and that's perfect. That's
You've been enjoying your sherry vinegar this week, eh?
It's my flavor of the month. Sherry vinegar. Put it on everything. All right, beans.
Oh,
where we
sauteed.
At?
Sauteed.
All I do for the, I'm gonna pop the egg over here. All I need for the mushies into a pan. Mushrooms are like, whenever you cook mushrooms, consider them to be like steaks, okay?
Okay.
So once they hit the pan, don't do anything. Brown them first before you add your garlic, before you add your salt, before you add your pepper, before you add your herbs.
Okay.
That's the trick. We're doing
See
little cute little buttons. That's
Very
gonna go
nice.
In. Okay, let's talk about what we got going.
Okay, there's a production
okay.
line here,
Beans,
man.
Bacon, Ooh. Bangers, mushies, tomatoes, back pudding, fried egg. Let's plate this a bad wrap real quick.
Oh, wow, and look at that. Look at how the water's cooked out and how that bacon is just rendering.
Gee, I've got a done version over there. We're going to send some of that to the bed a little later, but have a look. What do you
this
think? South Africa, we're not done. You got to let us know about your top breakfast in bed. We're doing it. We're doing it. We're doing it. There we go. I'm going to take this over to my boy, Raul.
This looks spectacular, man.
You want to take it? Please take it.
I'm going to take it. He needs an orange juice as well, because it's just so lovely.
Wake him up gently, okay?
All right. I need you to just run and jump on the bed. All right, come, gang. Done. In 3, 2, 1.
Look, I brought your breakfast in bed, Raul. It's not your birthday every day, but today's your day.
Whoa.
Because you guys had such a wonderful night last night.
So, Africa, the thing is, I think Raul genuinely did fall asleep in his bed.
What is this feeling of love? Is this breakfast in bed?
This is what it feels like, my friend.
I've never fucked before.
And no one's going to take it from you.
Is this for me?
Yeah, the crew's not going to come and take your food. You can eat it. Normally, the cameraman chowed long before it gets to us. Absolutely amazing stuff. If you want to recreate this beautiful English breakfast, in fact, do it better. And show us online. Hit us up on the Expresso Show, any of our social pages. In fact, and if you missed any of the ingredients and some of those tips, of course, we'll have it on expressoshow.com.
I think I'm going to cry.
What do you think, eh?
I think I'm going to cry. It's the best moment ever.
I feel like I
want to cuddle
you while you cry, man. If yours is better than this, we want to see it.
Mm.
Now I feel like I've missed out.
Whenever you have something really cold, and then you get this short, sharp kind of sensation, that's sensitivity. It can get worse. The problem is not going to go away by itself. I always recommend Sensodyne. It's specially designed to care for their sensitive teeth. And I've had people coming back to me saying it's made a difference. It works.
It's my Feel Good Breakfast Show.
Oh, yes, Mzansi, welcome back. Your Feel Good Breakfast Show. And, oh, this conversation is exciting me so much. Clearly, you can see by my face. Now, Crush is bringing you another episode of Unlock Your 100% on SABC tonight at 7:30 p.m. Now, I've been on an absolutely incredible journey to help unlock viewers 100% and help live their full potential. Now, with dreams coming true across the country, we sit down with another lucky entrant, now officially a friend of mine and someone that you're going to probably see a lot more of. We're talking about Mini Hadebe, all the way from Cape Town. Yes, right, John. Home soil, an aspiring social media content creator, and I think she's also got a couple other things up her sleeve, but yeah, she is in the flesh. Mini, how are you doing?
I am good. I'm so excited.
Oh, very excited to have you here and also to see your episode tonight. Now, you got to be a content creator to unlock your 100%. What were some of the things you learned that we'll perhaps see tonight on that episode without giving too much away?
Okay.
It's a tricky question.
It's fine. So I learned so much, hey. I think I got to realize that I do not know a lot, especially when it comes to the technicalities of content creation, the steadiness, what to look out for, what to bring to the viewers or whoever you want to follow on your page. But I learned so much.
Yeah, you did. And even me, while we were on the show together, I was kind of learning through you as you went through these experiences, and I didn't realize how important content creation actually is when you're kind of trying to do anything in that front-end space, right? So maybe the question to you is, in your experience from what we learned, do you think content creation is like a good, let's say, career choice? Is it something that's easy? Is it something you can just walk into? Is there quite a bit of work that needs to go into it?
I think it's perfect, actually, because the world is shifting towards technology a lot.
Yeah.
So in order to get yourself out there, whether it's whatever faculty or whatever you're into, you know, you engage more with people there. And I think it's something to invest in because, you know, it requires consistency. And, you know, in order for people to love and to follow you, they need to be sure that every time, maybe every day, we're going to see Mini.
Yeah.
Every week. So
I want my daily dose of Mini.
Yes. And also just being, you know, open in terms of what you put out there. Mm. You can't really, you don't have to focus on the same thing or whatever everybody else is doing. Mm. There's so much to look out for. I mean, on the show, you're gonna see that we actually explore fashion too, which is actually, you know, something anyone can
do. That was fun.
Did you enjoy
really cool.
it?
I loved it.
Oh.
I loved it. I loved it so much.
Well, you know, there are so many, I feel like content creators, you look left, right, and center, and there's quite a few. So I think for anyone breaking into that space right now, you need to have that unique something. What advice do you have for aspiring content creators that, you know, want to take a page from your book? Apart from watching tonight's episode, what other advice do you have for them?
For me, I'd say that, you know, do not follow on, you know, other people's footsteps. You know, create something new. People like new things. Like, for example, with even like presenting, I know that people wouldn't like to see another Bonang or anything like anybody else that they've seen. They want to see something new. So I'd say explore, find new ways to engage people in, you know, different ways that you can. Yeah.
So I gotta ask, with the way you took this challenge on and absolutely, in my opinion, slayed it, you really took the education and did something so spectacular with it. I feel like you ticked that box when it comes to content creator. Obviously, it's something we consistently have to do now going forward and working on that brand, but I feel like there's something more from you. I think like this is kind of like a stepping stone. You've unlocked your 100% when it comes to content creation, but what's next for Mini? What's your eye set on when it comes to the next accolade that you want to smash in your life?
Okay, so definitely I'm going to be on people's screens.
Yeah.
Because that's the end goal. I'm a lover of presenting. I'm a lover of art. Also in acting, I'm found. Voiceover artist also. So I'm an all-rounder, just an artist. So the next big thing for me is definitely just, you know, entering the industry as much as I can. And also I just want to be so relatable to everyone that's watching me that even, I mean, I'm originally from KZN. So I want that kid in KZN to say, hey, she came from KZN, but she made it. You know what I mean? She was a dreamer. She chased it and she achieved it. So that is what we're going to be expecting from
you. I love it.
And I love you. your voice. I'm just sitting here. I'm just like, I just want to listen to you. I just want to listen.
True,
I
you're
just
right.
want you to stop talking.
Oh, thank you so much. Actually, not the weird thing is, I am one person who loves listening to her voice notes.
Oh, see, you've got the good voice. You've got the good voice. Well, Minnie, please don't go anywhere. We would love for you to hang out with us today. And for you at home, stand the chance of winning a bed from the Bed Shop. And that is valued at 5,000 Rand to help you unlock your night's rest. Now, to enter, you need to watch the show tonight on SABC 2. You do not want to miss out on Minnie's journey.
Oh, yeah.
Comment on the competition post on the Clover Crush Facebook, Twitter, or Instagram pages and tell us how you winning this prize will help you unlock your 100%. Don't forget to include hashtag crush in your answer. The competition will close on the 16th of April at midnight. The R's and C's can be found on clover.co.za.
Yeah, now one more thing, of course, Mzansi, do not miss tonight's show, 7:30 p.m. SABC 2. And if you want a little teaser, check this out.
It's The Crush. Unlock your 100% TV show. Meet Minnie Hadebe, an aspiring media personality and content creator that needs a little bit of help growing her audience and creating content that leaves a lasting impression. You ready for this?
I am so ready.
You want to take videos, photos, different things.
Honey is really helping me a lot here because my camera skills are terrible.
Let's create
a reel. Exciting.
That means we're having a fashion show.
Watch the show on SABC 2 every Wednesday at 7:30 p.m.
Well, just maybe it looked like that. What's the craziest thing you've had for breakfast in bed? If it is something like this, please, we need to see the picture. But we put it to you guys this morning to let us know what is the most insane thing you've had for breakfast in bed. So let's hear from the OG, Josephine Pickstone, saying, good morning, fam. The craziest breakfast I had in bed was fish and chips with a cuppa. I'm there for that. That's perfectly fine. I love it. Well done, Josephine. Then Tyrell saying, good morning, fam. The craziest breakfast I've ever had in bed. Mutton curry and tea. Oh, a little bit of leftover mutton curry from the night before. Immaculate. I love it. Then Pam Burmeister saying, leftover trifle on the 26th of December, Boxing Day. That's perfectly acceptable. It's not crazy enough. We need more. We need crazier. Let us know. What's the craziest thing you've had for breakfast in bed, especially if you're a parent and have had a child make breakfast in bed for like a Mother's Day or that special occasion? We want to see it. Twigs, leaves, and all. We'd love to hear from you. Keep that conversation going. You can hit us up on any of our social media pages or drop us a voice note or a video or picture. 063-408-8863. That is the WhatsApp line to use. Now, I would normally say, all right, time to get out of bed and start working out. But no, stay in bed and start working out. Let's see if we can get that right.
I mean, have you ever been told to stay in bed to get your workout done? Now, while many trainers and fitness experts might balk at the idea, you know, of doing a workout on your mattress, we rounded up a few WHO suggestions to, you know, get the blood flowing, stretch out, and do a little bit of toning without even changing out of your PJs. Now, we have a very, very special and sleepy coach here to help us. Natalie? Live TV.
5 more minutes.
No, not five more minutes. But have a look at this. I'll get her to wake up. Have a look at this to see what we are talking about. Listen, she is awake. She is ready to show us how we can do the perfect workout from the comfort of your own bedroom. Hi.
Good morning.
I love the hair clip.
The morning voice, that's usually what comes. So how are you, Zoe?
I'm good. How are you? I'm trying to figure out how we're going to do this.
So usually, Zoe, what happens? We don't want to do this. We don't want to get out of this comfort, beautiful. And not everyone gets the beautiful wake-up call, the alarm going,
and the
breakfast in
singing.
Bed. So some of us has to really get out and, you know, get that vuma going. So how do we get that vuma going? So I'm going to have you literally. It's all about the start of the day.
This is an interesting bed.
So you're in bed.
Yeah.
And usually not having a good pillow, not sleeping well. What happens? We all don't sleep as little princesses.
No.
Some of us sleep like this. We're like, it's a whole ninja move happening here in the bed. So you wake up already, the neck is stiff. Okay, some of us wake up, the neck is stiff. Your back is, so we're actually just going to start it there. So alarm has gone off. You've already pressed snooze for the fifth time.
Okay.
Guilty as charged. And now you got to get out. So just a simple thing, just using your neck from side to side. So for some of us who did not have a good sleep and the neck, okay, just normal. There we go, gently, four more, and three, and two, and
where's your microphone?
It's my microphone.
There we go, it's okay, under the gown. There we go.
Okay.
So just want to make sure everyone can hear you properly.
Beautiful, two more, and one more. Now you're going to keep that one because that one side is really Aina. Like I had the other day, a little one stole my pillow.
Oh.
Mom woke up sleeping on a continental pillow. Not good. Okay, there we go.
Not the support she's used to.
There we go. Now the other one, we're going to work. Let's just do abdominal area here.
While we're
sometimes
here.
People thinking,
comfortable.
Like, how can I do tummy workout? All you're doing, you are pulling your navel to your spine. So you pull it in and you release. And you pull it in. And you release. Oh, I love the music it's playing. It's actually making us more sleepy now.
I know, but it's okay. It's
pull
okay.
It in, pull it in. Four more. And three more. Ooh, and two more. So you literally activated the core.
Uh-huh.
Simple thing. You could take that a minute or two. Now you're going to really have to get out of bed now, okay?
Well, see, so this is also great for if you're watching Espresso right now from your bed.
Yeah. Let me see your toes is obviously down there. Now the back is
aimed. I hope I don't have holes in my
back.
Socks.
No, but usually you sleep with Michi Match socks. So sorry for us having Michi Match socks here. So you're going to go and you're going to reach slowly. Ooh, come to, yes, touch the toes. Ooh. And bring it back. Give me one more.
Oh, that's a good one.
Okay, where are you feeling
it? I've never woken up this way before.
I know, but it's
where
just getting your day started. Now hold on to the toes. Ooh, Aina. Four more, three, two, and one. And now I'm gonna give you the last one, which I think you saw in the video. So you're literally gonna then
get out of bed. Okay, this is where you
so
get out of bed.
Choose to get out of bed. And as you have your bed there, it's the normal plank, which I'm sure we all no, and some of us dread it and hate, but you're going to use your bed now as a support. If you've got socks on, it's obviously depending on the floor, just make sure that you are safe. So you're going to right arm, left arm, and all you're going to do, just plank. Now, what do we do when we wake up? Some of us, we grab the phone. So why not grab the phone, watch those little WhatsApps, yes, or some of us find ourselves just meditating or finding, some of us even pray in the morning. So yeah, some of two in one.
Two in
four
one.
Four more, and three, I know, and two. And then the one we're gonna do, I'm gonna keep you there, just sliding your, like you know the mountain climbers?
Let me see.
Okay, let me show, can you
I
see?
I know, I'm just trying to get a break here.
Mountain climbers. Oh, and this floor is just lovely, just letting you go. Four more. Oh, and three, we don't really want to do this, but we do it. Last one, and you bring it up. And I think as you start, you just breathe in, and you're like, what am I going to wear now? My day's ahead, but you've started good, and you've given yourself a good workout.
Oh.
Here we go.
Well, Natalie Daniels, it's always so great to have you here. Of course, make sure you catch up with her at Fit Mums. You do not want to miss out on the wonderful exercise ideas and things that she has for not only moms, but women and anyone in general. The whole idea is to get you moving, even if you are in bed. So now you have no more excuses.
Yes, Mzansi, welcome back. Your Feel Good Breakfast Show. It's time to get pumped. It's time to get excited because we are about to bring on a winner. Yeah, so before we get into it, what do you call a bunny with a large brain? An egghead. You see what I did there? Now it's of course a new day and another chance for 3 lucky viewers to win up to 10,000 Rand with Golden Cloud and Beacon Mellow's Easter Wheel. So let's hop right into it. So our first contestant for this morning, let's put our hands together for the one and only Samuel Tluaele. Samuel, how you doing? Samuel, you there?
Fine, sir. Yes, I'm here, sir.
How you doing this morning?
I'm well, and you?
Oh, fantastic, man. I'm excited because it's time to play the game. Before we do, I just want to read out your reply to the competition post, and you said, with extra spicy hot cross buns with hen's eggs. Hashtag, let the hunt begin. And Mzansi, that's how simple it was for Samuel to get involved in this competition. So, Samuel, are you feeling lucky today, my friend?
Yes, very, very lucky.
Okay, so let me just explain to you again how the game works. All you got to do is shout out the word spin, and I will spin the wheel on your behalf, and whatever number it lands on, we'll then find out what prize that correlates to. And man, there's lots of good stuff up here. Make sense?
Okay.
You ready?
Yes, sir.
Okay, whenever you're ready, tell me the magic word, and I'll do the honors.
Spin!
Yes! What's it gonna be, ladies and gentlemen? Samuel's looking for the big bucks. Is it gonna be one? It's one! It's one! What is one? What is one? Let's find out! It is...
10,000 Rand!
Samuel! Ladies and gentlemen, Samuel has just taken away 10,000 Rand! Samuel, are you still on the phone? Are you still there?
Yes, I'm there.
Where are you? Please don't run anywhere. Don't do anything crazy. I need to keep you on the line, man. How does it feel, okay, brother? 10,000 Rand's yours.
Yeah! I feel very excited.
Samuel, are you alone or with your family as well?
I'm with my family.
Oh, yes. This is even better. So this is perfect timing for Easter. What are you going to do with all this money?
I'm gonna take my family to a vacation.
Yes, they absolutely deserve it. That's the best way you can spend this cash, man. I'm wishing you nothing but magic. Thank you so much for entering this incredible competition. How easy was that? The Beacon and Golden Cloud spin and win wheel. You have owned it, brother. Ladies and gentlemen, Samuel, 10,000 Rand! Oh, Samuel, anything you want to say?
I say thank you for the opportunity, and may the others also be encouraged to join the Golden Crown and Bacon competition.
Oh, man, have an incredible one. Thank you so much. And, of course, Mzansi, remember, there are still 2 chances to spin and win today, so don't go anywhere. Sure, I'm a little bit nervous. There's more prizes to be won, and it could be you. Woo-hoo-hoo! Yes!
There's no sweeter way to enjoy Easter than with homemade treats.
Oh, well, listen, speaking of Beacon and Golden Cloud, we have to now do a recipe after that amazing win of 10,000 Rand. I have Sassy Bakes in studio, and of course, Easter is a great time to bring the whole family together, and this is a recipe you want to include them for. I'm seeing Easter eggs, I'm seeing some yummy mallows over there, I'm seeing
the
golden egg, I'm seeing chocolate. Sassy, tell me, what are we making?
Today, we're going to make a chocolate mint cake.
Chocolate mint. And what is it about the Golden Cloud cake mixes that you love so much?
It just makes your cake so much lighter, so fluffy and super moist. And I just love it.
You want a moist
Absolutely.
Cake. There's nothing worse than having dry cake.
No.
Okay. So where do we start with
this? It's a simple recipe. I mean, everything is ready packaged for you. It's just opening the box, as simple as that. Take out the packaging. That's our icing. It comes ready with our icing. And there's our Golden Cloud bake. We're going to open this baby right there.
Should I get going on the icing and just soften up our butter for us?
Fantastic. Everything goes right into our bowl.
Fantastic. It makes it easy. You just add the wet ingredients.
Now we're going to add our 2 eggs. This is how easy it is. In with our milk. ready with the oil. And voila. We give this mix.
I think I got all the butter in.
That's fantastic, darling. You just stand there, you look absolutely gorgeous.
I just made a big mess with
them. Don't worry, it's nothing that an Easter egg can't fix. Put on some beacon.
I'll put in the icing mixture. How's
do that,
that?
Do
and
that.
Hopefully that will loosen up all the butter in the whisks.
I mean, Zoe, I want you just to smell that. Look at this.
Oh, you get the mintiness coming through.
This is so easy. And you know what? You can impress all your friends, your family, and everyone with this easy recipe.
You can indeed. And you know what's amazing is we are using the delicious choc mint cake and icing mix today. And we also, you know, it comes in vanilla. You get the carrot cake mix. There's also the plain chocolate. You really can go and pick and choose the flavor that you like. And Golden Cloud cake mixes are not only the best option for flop proof bakes, that they are soft and fluffy, and as Sassy said, they're also super duper moist and so easy to make. All you need to add are the eggs, the oil, the water or milk, and they only take about 30 minutes to bake. Look at that.
I mean, look at this.
Beautiful and creamy. I'm gonna grab some scissors or a knife.
So all we have to do now, Zoe, we're gonna take this mixture and we're gonna divide it into our 20 centimeter tins into two equal amounts and bake for 30 minutes. And there you go.
There we go. So now we need to fix this icing piece.
Go for it, darling.
So we add the icing.
There we go.
And we just go for it
very slowly, gently.
We might have to get the butter out, eh?
Yeah, but just you continue mixing for me.
I love how you move back. You know it's gonna make a mess.
Rather you than me, love.
let's loosen.
Yeah.
Let's so loosen just, this up.
No.
With that.
This.
I don't know why I thought it was a good idea to just go in with the butter. You know what, Sassy? I'm a disaster in the kitchen.
No, you're not, darling.
But this recipe will still succeed despite my cooking capabilities.
That's why you've got me. There we go.
She's here to help. So we'll get going on this. Now, once we have our cake ready and done, I love what you did here with the chocolate. So talk me through the box that you made.
So quite simple. What I've done, I've taken this one, which is the beacon egg, melted it into a microwave-safe bowl, into the microwave at 30-second increments, and the same with my white chocolate. I've put them all together. In fact, I can actually just show you.
Please do.
So what you do, you take some greaseproof paper into your pan, and take your chocolate, beacon chocolate, and look at that.
So smooth, baby. Smooth.
And you're just going to do that. You pour right. That right over. Keep it at that. We're just gonna go in with our paper. Can you hold on to that side, Mila?
For the paper?
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Smooth it out like that.
This is me multitasking.
I love it, I love it. Look at this girl. And look at, the butter's off the whisk.
It's getting there.
I'm impressed.
We're getting there.
I am so impressed.
It's not supposed to be this difficult. You really have to maybe just mix some things with the butter before you put the whisk to it.
So let me just give you one trick as well, though. When you do that, I want you to lift your paper and just give it a quick squiggle. And that smooths out the chocolate.
Oh, look at that. Look at that.
One, two, smooth. And then we take one of this.
I stole your spoon now.
No, it's fine. What we're going to do, I just want to go in with some white. You're going to go in with some white and just do it over like that.
Oh, and that's how you add a bit of...
Help, you know, let the kids help you. Kids love doing things like this.
Get the marbling effect going.
And then we just get the marbling effect going like that.
Oh, fantastic.
Just move it around like that, baby.
And you'll allow that to dry?
Allow this to dry, just to set.
To set, that's the word.
But remember when you're busy tempering chocolate, when it's at, it needs to be at a certain temperature. So we allow chocolate just to cool until it just slightly gets hot, and then you start cutting. Then you can cut any shapes using a nice sharp knife, non-serrated knife.
There we go. And then you can add those chocolate shards
to your
cake.
You can add your beacon chocolate, you can add your Easter eggs, you can add some love, you can add some sass, whatever you want.
I love that. You add love and sass to this. And to get your hands on this delicious recipe, you can visit our website, expressoshow.com. And don't forget, In fact, don't go anywhere because it's almost time for us to call our second Golden Cloud and Beacon Mellows Wheel spinner for today. We already gave away 10,000 Rand. You'll need to stay tuned to find out how much more we'll be giving away.
There's no sweeter way to enjoy Easter than with homemade treats.
It's my feel-good breakfast show. Welcome back, you beauties. Thank you so much for tuning in. Your timing is perfect. Dropping in hot from Mitchell's Plain this morning, rising musician Tashe, whose inspiration varies from track to track, draws influence from the genres of deep soul, a little bit of hip-hop there, some old-school rock, a little bit of pop. He has found his formula, and his music is rooted in personal experiences and progressing when odds are against you, which is, I think, why so many people are identifying. But let's give you a little taste.
You got me feel, yeah, you got me feeling nauseous. Running through my mind, yeah, you running like a mosh pit. Girl, yeah, you feel, yeah, you really feeling toxic. Really feeling nauseous, throw my cup of toxins. Girl, yeah, I gave you my heart and you took it. You at the key.
You know when you can't not move when the boot drops, you got something special. Ladies and gentlemen, give him a big feel good. Welcome to the show, Mr. Tashe. Hey, welcome to Espresso! Yes, baby.
Thank you so much.
I always try to sound like a festival full of people to speak to you because I know it takes a lot for performers to get up at this time of the day and bring it. Listening to your sound check, I'm like, oh, this is just what we need.
Thank you so much.
So, buddy, I've got to ask, in this crazy industry that we find ourselves in, and as you start to kind of blow up, because I think that's, you, hopefully you are feeling that happening right now. There's a reason why you've ended up on this stage. How are you feeling about your musical journey right now after these crazy years that we've been through? Where's your headspace at, man?
It's been an amazing journey. It's been really crazy. Lots of ups and downs, you know.
Yeah.
But I thank God for where I am at today. I wouldn't be here. Thank you guys for having me. No, it's crazy. I've been watching the show all the years and now I'm finally here myself. So I'm very proud of myself, you know. I feel like the future's looking very bright for myself. And yeah, I'm feeling great.
You got to keep pumping out good tunes. That's the bottom line here. Yeah. You can look good, you can have the mode, you can capitalize on the trend. All of that is great. You got to step up with the talent at some point. That's and great. It feels like our artists are getting a gap to do that right now.
Yeah.
Why is this your time, do you think? What has fallen into place right now that is just working so well, bro?
I just feel like South Africa and Cape Town industry as well, the industry is opening up so much. Right, there's so many local artists that are actually getting an opportunity, a platform to do their thing. So this is the perfect time for any artist, matter of fact, to like capitalize on what they're doing. And I feel that at this point in time, my music is right. People are jamming. People are showing me more love than ever. So this is the time for me to do my thing, you know?
Because they can relate. And I think the fact that your journey is interwoven with this rising above.
Yeah.
So many people are looking for those words now, finding their spirit animal to help them rise above. And we're going to help you do it this morning. We've got a performance coming in just a moment. We're going to make you wait just a few more moments so you can warm up the muscles in bed, as we've shown you. And we'll bring you up to speed with some of those news headlines. Then this young man is going to show you what he's got. Stick around.
Oh, yes, we cannot wait for it. But for now, though, it's about to hit the hour, and it's time for official duties once again. And starting on national news headlines, Gauteng Premier Panyaza Lesufi says 3,000 of the 6,000 young people who are being trained as wardens to patrol crime hotspots are ready to hit the streets from May the 1st. Now, he says there will be the ears and eyes of communities in every ward in Gauteng. But meanwhile, six police officers have been arrested in Cape Town on charges of corruption. Now, two sergeants and four constables aged between 31 and 42 were arrested yesterday morning by the Maitland Emergency Patrol. Well, sticking to national headlines, unions representing the majority of SA's public sector workers have confirmed that they have accepted the government's revised 7.5% wage increase for the next 2 years. Now, the government initially offered 4.7%, but upped its offer to prevent protracted wage negotiations and a prolonged strike. Now, the national manager of the Public Servants Association, Claude Nyker, said most of the unions represented had taken that offer to their constituencies and their members for general approval. Well, from our national news headlines, we head over to international news. Now, new clashes erupted in France yesterday between protesters and police as tens of thousands took to the streets to vent their anger against President Emmanuel Macron's pension reform, which has sparked the biggest domestic crisis of his second mandate. Now, the day of action is the 10th since protests began in mid-January against the law, which includes raising the retirement age from 62 to 64 years. Now, this development has become a major challenge to Macron, who won a second term in office last year. Carrying on with the international news headlines, Egypt will soon allow Iranians traveling with tour groups to obtain visas on arrival in the south of its Sinai Peninsula with a view to extending access to other parts of the country. Now, this being said by Egyptian tourism ministry officials themselves. Now, it comes as some Middle Eastern countries, including Egypt, are taking steps to ease regional tensions. Now, Egypt's Sunni Muslim Arab ally, Saudi Arabia, as well as the Shiite Muslim Iran, announced this month that they would restore diplomatic relations. Next up in some exciting news, a novice Australian treasure hunter with an inexpensive metal detector has hit the jackpot big time, finding a 4.6 kilogram rock containing gold worth some $200,000. Oh, wow. Now, the man who doesn't wish to be named did so in the state of Victoria's gold fields. Now, the heart of Australia's gold rush in the 1800s, Darren Kemp, who valued and bought the specimen, said it was the largest he'd seen in his 43-year career. Now, Kemp said he thought it was just another case of fool's gold when a man with a large backpack casually strolled into his prospecting office in Geelong, southwest of Melbourne, and dropped the 4.6 kg rock into his hand, asking, and quote, "Do you think there's $10,000 worth in it?" Well, Kemp took one look at the rock and replied, "Try $300,000. Now, the 4.6 kg rock contained 2.6 kilograms of gold, and Kemp says the man's only comment was, Oh, the wife will be happy. Well, needless to say and to mention, Camp Abort the Rock. Well, congratulations to those that venture and search for the goods. But for now, it's time to carry on with the rest of the headlines. And here's the latest for the sport, and G has it all.
Thank you so much. Well, let's start with some pretty good news. First up, from an AFCON perspective, South Africa have secured a place at next year's Africa Cup of Nations AFCON finals. That was after a hard-fought 2-1 away win over Liberia, so proving their credentials under Brewis already. So Pravana Bafana guaranteed now a top two finish in that Group K alongside the already qualified Morocco. Very tough group. And that came courtesy of goals from Sakele Lepasa and Mihlali Mayambela. And Bafana held their nerve to get the victory and secure their place at the Nations Cup for the first time since 2019 back in Egypt. Then on to cricket, not the best news. The West Indies showed some fire. They claimed a 7-run win in that third and final T20 to win the three-match series 2-1 and maintain their record of having never lost a T20 series in South Africa. So just a few days on from that record run chase where the Proteas were insane, they won the toss and decided to chase again, which seemed like the right choice, I'm sure. The visitors were scoring at a pretty good pace. Regular wickets meant that they found themselves 161 for 8 with 4 overs left. Romario Shepherd stepped in with a 44 not out and Alzari Joseph 14 to put on 59 for that ninth wicket, including a vital last over 26 to help their side post that 220 for 8. In response, Reeza Hendricks continued his amazing form. He was the mainstay for the host, scoring 83. And Joseph, though, he did it again with the ball in hand as well, taking 5 for 40 as the Windies held on for that memorable win. Then on to rugby. We can get excited about the shorter format now. The Blitzbucks, it's that tough, this draw. It's making me nervous. They were handed a pretty tough draw for the prestigious Hong Kong Sevens series. That, of course, takes place this weekend. The 8th in the 11 for this year's calendar. And it sees South Africa contest Pool D alongside New Zealand, Ireland and Kenya, all of which have beaten the Blitzbucks at some point this season. So a bit of a hoodoo pool for us, but finishing in the top two of this pool means the Blitzbucks will play one of the top two teams from Pool A, and that contains Canada, Samoa, Fiji and Argentina, all pretty tough prospects as well. Hong Kong 7 starts this Friday. South Africa take on Ireland in the first match, 9:04 in the morning, so set your alarm right now, and that's of course SA time. Then on to athletics. The International Olympic Committee has now recommended that Russian and Belarusian athletes are allowed to compete under a neutral flag, but as yet they have not made a decision on Paris 2024 officially. So this recommendation only extends to individual athletes at this stage, not the teams. So the IOC's executive board has also told international federations and event organizers that athletes and support personnel who actively support the war in the Ukraine or who are contracted to the military should not be permitted to compete. The story will undoubtedly evolve over the next couple of weeks, so we'll watch it closely. Hopefully the roads aren't looking quite as dramatic. There will be a few incidences to take you through. Zozo is going to get you to work safely.
Thank you, Graham. Well, let's start off with traffic in Bellville, Cape Town. There's been an accident on the N1 inbound after Durban Road. The left lane is currently obstructed. There are delays, so please approach with caution. And then in Cape Town, in the Cape Flats, there's a stationary vehicle on the R300 northbound. It's before Van Riebeek Road. The emergency lane is blocked. Please approach with caution. And in KZN, in Pietermaritzburg, there are ongoing roadworks on the N3 northbound, and that's before Peter Brown. The middle lane is closed. Please drive carefully when passing through. That's your traffic. Let's take another look at your weather. And we start off with some international news. More than 50% of the species that live in Australia's shallow reefs have declined in numbers as ocean waters warmed over the past decade. That's the alarming findings from the country's largest survey yet of marine life, which found that the number of more than 500 species had fallen. This is very concerning, a study led author and University of Tasmania marine ecology professor Graham Edgar said. The research published in Nature looked at the numbers of 1,057 common species found in 1,636 different locations. 57% of them were in decline, Edgar noted. Of them, some 28% had seen their numbers fall by 30% or more, enough to qualify for threatened status on the International Union for Conservation of Nature Red List. There's evidence that the climate crisis is a main driver of these declines, as cool water species were the most harmed, while some warm water species increased. Population numbers tended to fall after marine heat waves. Bringing it back home, we look at those sunrise views. And first up for your 7 a.m. update is Yuzair Swain, who sent in this beautiful photo from the mother city. Look at the multiple tones in the sky glowing up. Then Sipa Balwe is out on the jetty and snapped this view looking at the calm waters and that yellow shade in the sky. Then we got this one from Ronnie, who is in Margate Beach and headed out for a run on the beach with her bestie. What a great way to start off your day. And then we have a Shanaz from The Bluff who sent in this beautiful real nature-filled view with a perfect green hedge of soft blues in the sky reflecting over the ocean. What a great photo. If you have a sunrise view to share with us, our number is 063-408-8863. We would love to see your sunrise views. But let's get into today's temperatures. If you're in Polokwane, your low is 14, your high 28. Mbombela, 34. Pretoria, 14, 26. Johannesburg, 14, with a high of 24. Mahikeng, 13, 27. Klerksdorp, 14, 27. If you're in Kimberley, 7's your low, 29 your high. Bloemfontein, 6, 25. Richards Bay, 19, with a high of 28. Pietermaritzburg, your low is 14, your high 26. If you're in Durban, 20's your low, 25 your high. Mthatha, 12, 24. East London, 13, 23. Craddock, 7 with a high of 25. Gqeberha, 14 with a high of 22. Rainy conditions for George, 12's your low, 18 your high. Cape Town, 14 with a high of 19 for today. Worcester, 7, 22. Sutherland, 3, 19. And Upington, your low is 11, your high 29 degrees Celsius. Well, that's where we leave your weather for now. I'll have a final update shortly after 8.
Having Tashé in studio is a rare opportunity for us to see an artist becoming. His wave is undoubtedly breaking, and you're going to understand why. This is going to be an earworm. Once it's in your head, it's there for the rest of the day, and we are here for that. Ladies and gentlemen, to take it away and kickstart this midweek party, it's Tashé with Falling to Pieces. Enjoy, my brother.
I'm falling to pieces. I know you can see me. I know you can see it. I can almost feel it. Drowning in the deep end. I can barely breathe in. I'm falling to pieces. I show you my dreams. Yeah, I saw you in my dreams. Yeah, you play on my mind. Running, running, running out of time. I've been overthinking it now. My life's on the line. I'm falling to pieces. I hope you can see it. I've been counting money, but they don't kill my demons. All this damn anxiety, I found my depression. Tell me what's your secret, wait till you see them. I'm falling to pieces, I'm falling to pieces. I know you can see me, I know you can see it. I can almost feel it, drowning in the deep end. I can barely breathe and I'm falling to pieces. I'm falling to pieces, I'm falling to pieces. I know you can see me, I know you can see it. I can almost feel it, drowning in the deep end. I can barely breathe and I'm falling to pieces.
Yes, man, we love it. Oh, take me back to that party. Just let it roll. We absolutely love it. Available for downloads.
Of course.
Do
it. Streaming platforms, everything.
Absolutely love it. Where can people connect with you to find out where they can see you perform live, my friend? What's the best way to connect?
So you can catch me on all social media, basically. But if you're really trying to stay up to date with what I'm doing, I actually have a website, dashay.com, you know. Keep it business professional.
100%.
You can see everything that I'm doing, when I'm doing it, the time that I'm doing it. So that's
love
the vibes.
And he does answer back. He does answer back. You might collaborate. Just saying. Might collaborate with the young producer out there. Buddy,
thank you so much.
Love that sound, because that sound is strong, my friend. It's the sound of 2023, and I think this is going to be his year. Two more performances coming your way. Don't move a muscle. Are you struggling to find a transparent and honest broker? Well, get to know Okta FX. It offers clear trading conditions without hidden commissions, fees, and 0% swaps. In addition to that, depositing and withdrawing money has never been easier, with convenient payment options including Ozo and popular South African banks. And rest assured, as a regulated broker here in South Africa, Okta FX prioritizes your safety and your security. So join the thousands of satisfied traders who trust Okta FX for their trading needs.
It's my feel-good breakfast show.
Good morning, South Africa. Welcome back to the second installment of the Culinary Hotline Bling!
Ching, ching, ching!
We are having so much fun with our theme this morning, breakfast in bed. We're on to our second recipe, and I'm bringing the guy that actually did fall asleep earlier this morning while laying in the bed. Raul de Mornay.
I legitimately was like bossing out a little bit there. That's a dangerous place to be.
That bed is so comfy.
Yeah,
so
man.
Comfy.
Okay. So listen, bud, we've got some good stuff happening here. Mm-hmm. Things that I don't know about breakfast in bed. But a lot of people online have been commenting about what their favorite dish is or their favorite breakfast option is in bed. And we've got a comment from Shireen Abrams. Says, firstly, good morning, Clem and the team. Happy Wednesday. I normally make breakfast in bed for my husband and daughter. They love scrambled eggs, bacon, and some tomatoes. And their favorite is ever with toast and a cup of coffee or juice. Loving the Culinary Hotline as always. Have an awesome day, team. Lots of love. Well, Shireen, I like that. I love the comment, and I think it's definitely the inspiration that we've come for
yes.
This session, right?
Ever on toast, very much on trend right now, but for good reason. It tastes delicious.
And it's like not only just confined to, let's say, breakfast, right? It's a lunch option. It's a supper option. It's anytime goes, but in bed, oh, it's going to be so good.
It's so good. Natasha Pearson from Facebook also commented, and she said, fried eggs, avo, on toast, whole wheat toast,
ooh,
by
nice.
The way. A little bit of spring onion, chives, cream cheese spread. And again, that little sprinkle of chives is what takes it from just being like a good breakfast to a a great breakfast. Cool, and it shows man. You cared.
Yes.
Absolutely.
I like that.
She also says she likes hers with a cup of cortado. So who's the barista in your house? Nice. I really want to know who's doing that. Okay, so we're going to work on this amazing recipe. And don't forget, at home, if you want this recipe, check it out on expressoshow.com. Also, we want to hear those voice notes. Send them through to 068-408-8863.
Beautiful stuff, right. man. All right, let's get into this because I want to pretend that I can make someone breakfast.
Raul, you actually come talking about barista. Sorry, cut you off. Talking about barista. You look like you're ready.
Look at the boy. Yeah, I'm ready, man. Yeah.
Hey, okay.
I got
one cortado coming up, please. Okay, so Raul, you're actually on avocado duty.
Okay.
Okay, so what I need you to do is to halve the avocado, take the pulp out, but professionally now. And then what I do is I always halve the avocado, twist it, take the pulp, hit with a knife, and then I launch the pulp. Okay? And then I need you to fan out the avo for me. That's for the toast.
Okay.
In the meantime, I'm going to show you...
What are you up to on that side?
I want to see this launch. And we'll,
so where did you say? I cut it off and then I twist it. All right?
You got
and
the...
Avo
you got
it,
the
do I just okay. like...
No, wait. You got, first, you got to you take the knife.
Okay,
then
take
you gotta
the knife.
Then you got to tap it. No, with the blade side. Blade
okay,
side.
Blade
tap
side.
The blade side.
What do you mean? Like the sharp
side? Yes.
Yeah.
Tap the stone.
Okay.
Twist. There we go. Oh, now, what I need you to do is not hurt. Don't hurt anyone, okay?
Who's it going to be?
In for the ground.
Oh, I see someone over here.
And you go, chuck.
Okay, guys, maybe don't do that in the kitchen because Mom's not going to be too impressed with you after that. I'll pick that up later. Don't worry. I apologize. But let's get back to this. I'll carry on fanning my avo. I'm sorry.
That was crazy. Okay, so you're going to fan your avo.
I got you.
Oh, wait. Shh. You have to be real quiet because... Graham's in bed, so we just need to just take it down a little bit. All Graham's right. catching a few Z's. So, okay, while you're doing your fanning, I'm going to show you a really cool way to fry your eggs. And we're bringing back an absolute icon that came out this year. It's the Woolies Chili Crunch. It's got the oil in there already. It's got the garlic, it's got the onion, it's got the chili. Fry
it's
your
just
eggs.
It's literally ready to go in the pan.
It is. So you're going to add a little bit of butter to your pan. Okay, normally we would add oil to this now so the butter doesn't burn, but instead of doing that, we're gonna go in with our chili crunch. Get that in there. Ooh, my spoon's got butter on it. There we go, doesn't matter.
No one's complaining about that.
You want it to melt, get a nice bit of... You see, once the butter starts melting, you need to spread it around so the egg has a little bit of that butter to kind of glide on.
Got you, yeah.
Immediately it smells amazing. It smells so good. Now, if you are scared of cracking eggs, you know, by getting shell into your pan, what you can do is first crack the egg into a smaller cup, then pour it into the hot pan. Instead of you putting egg in there and you're gonna try and start fishing it out.
And get all your egg shells out as well that have cracked in it.
It's a nightmare. So get your eggs in there.
Nice.
I'm gonna go for two eggs.
I wouldn't try this now, but someone actually told me you could literally take an egg like right on top of the pan and just drop it and it breaks perfectly. Have you ever tried that? We'll try that on the next Culinary Conundrum, maybe.
We might try that for the next segment, actually, now that you mentioned that. Talk to me about your eggs. How do you like your eggs?
I actually like them, like, sunny side up, man. I like that, like, good, healthy fat to kind of just blend in with the rest of our meal when I cut it through. So definitely sunny side up for me.
A great way to get that texture is with the set whites and the yolks all running. At this point, all you got to do is pop a lid on it, turn the heat down, and you'll fry it as you steam it.
Because often, like, this top just stays too runny, and then the bottom, like, overcooks itself, and it almost costs a burn.
There we go.
Nice.
I'm turning the heat down because that's quite hot. Add a bit of salt to it. How's your avo doing?
Avo's all fanned out, ready to go. What am I doing with it?
Cream cheese on your toast. When it comes to...
Yum.
Actually, true story, my favorite bread to have for breakfast vibes, or actually most of the time, okay?
Yeah.
The Willy's Tanta Anna. It's got the flavor. It's got the crushed wheat, and I think... Our viewer actually said she prefers the crushed wheat bread. This is the one.
What?
This
is the delicious one. I'm like not really educated. Tanta and a crushed whole brown bread.
Yes.
Okay.
So delicious. You can actually smell the nuttiness coming out the bread. You can hit it with the cream cheese. Be generous with it. Okay.
Generous coming up. All right.
There we go. The eggs are almost there.
Are these like open sides, open style sandwiches as well? We're not closing them.
Open sandwiches for me just make it like a little fancier.
Yeah, I like that too. And you can kind of see the magic that's really inviting you in to just take a scrumptious bite.
Exactly, I like that. So you're gonna cream cheese your other slice as well.
Got that.
To that, you're gonna add your avocado slices that you fanned out
on
so
top.
Beautifully,
all
so
right.
professionally. I'm gonna come through with the eggs. These eggs are looking so good. It's so simple but so satisfying. You don't need to overcomplicate it. Sometimes all you need is just good toast, a good fried egg, and you're winning.
And a lot of love, of course.
A lot of love.
Serving this up to the people we love in bed. I mean, how else can they enjoy this then with a little bit of extra love on the side, too?
I feel like the best way to start someone's day off is by serving them breakfast in bed. Yeah? Like, I've never...
I'm trying to think of what's better than that. I don't even know. I don't know. Maybe, Mzansi, you can come through. I can't think of anything better than that, especially to express how you feel or how much you care about someone.
Ooh,
it smells good.
Eggs on, a little bit of that chive. What I've also done for you is I showed you another variation of this recipe, and it's by poaching your eggs.
Okay.
And serving it on an English muffin instead.
Nice.
And then all I got to do to finish it up for you is to take it to our G that's catching
it. Take it to someone that probably hasn't slept this year yet.
Here we go. A little bit of that.
I'm pretty sure.
Here we go. Have you got a knife and fork? Take it to the...
Take it
to him.
Take me to the honours. I am honoured to be able to be the one that is presenting this man with probably the first experience he's ever had in his life.
What?
Hey, G-Man.
No, Tony Flex.
G-Man, I got something for you, brother.
Oh, look at this.
Believe it or not, this is not a dream. This is really happening. Breakfast
Are you
bed,
real?
Man.
Can I see the love antenna? Is it real?
It's real. You
it's
can touch
real.
It.
This is real life. This looks beautiful, man.
Enjoy,
I
brother.
I absolutely love it. I'm gonna sleep for like 2 more minutes and then I'll
okay,
get
you
if anyone touches, you're going
home. Mzansi, of course, let us know what your favorite dish is for breakfast. Flat. The culinary hotline will be black, so don't go anywhere.
Love antenna.
Enjoy. Sleep away.
Love is Love is a new reality TV series which will be broadcast on SABC2, and we're looking for contestants. You stand a chance of being featured on the show and are finding your love match. You can enter online on our website loveislove.tv, on Instagram at loveislove_ZA, or via Facebook at loveislove.tv. T's and C's apply and can be found on loveislove.tv. Entries close 31st March this year.
It's my feel-good breakfast show.
Welcome
Welcome back. It is your Feel Good Breakfast Show Espresso on S3. Now, we're about to bring you all the feel good feels that you need in our What's Trending on TikTok that brings you the Masaka Kids. Now, I'm pretty sure you've seen them on social media. Once you see their happy videos, you will know exactly who we are talking about.
It's contagious, yeah.
It really is contagious. And something I didn't know was the group consists of African children aged between 2 years and older, and many have lost one or both parents through war, famine, and disease. However, their charming smiles and vibrant dance moves will definitely melt your heart this Wednesday morning. Now, they represent all the children of a continent, and they also demonstrate the potential of African children to become strong leaders for a better future in their land. And joining us is content creator Mini Hadebe. She is here, and you do not want to miss out on her episode of Crush Unlock Your 100% tonight on SABC2. But do you know which videos I'm talking about the kids dancing?
I actually do, and they're so contagious. I love it. I mean, they just kill it all the time.
They really do. Now, if you're not sure which videos we are talking about, take a look at this. You can come now.
Cool is that? Yeah. Honestly, I think this is something that not only people that just want to express themselves can do, but it almost seems like you being a digital content creator, dance is like taking over when it comes to everybody's brand. Like, you need to show how you move in some way or another. I don't know if you've experienced this before, yeah?
I have, and I've seen, you know, the fact that challenges actually are a big thing, and, you know, dancing is very important because, I mean, I feel like it's a love language of its
own. Yeah, and I think for South Africans, it's like deep in our culture for sure. But living in South Africa, speaking of, the next song will definitely resonate with you. I mean, take a look at this. I love it. I'm trying to figure out, do these kids have bones in their legs? The way they like just bend it, it's amazing.
Talent.
Honestly.
Can you imagine? I mean, you know, as a content creator, you don't always get things right the first take. You sometimes have multiple takes. It takes practices to get everyone to know the dance moves. How much fun they must be having doing these dances.
I think they're having so much fun, especially because you can tell they actually dance even behind the scenes. It's like a family thing or like a cultural thing. So you can tell that, you know, they enjoy it, they love it. And I love how confident they are. So whenever you meet them, well, randomly, I'm sure you can just say, please dance for me. You definitely kill it.
I'm glad you do so.
Adorable. Well, we bet you'll see stars in this next video as the Masaka Kids Africana take on the viral Cuff It Challenge. Take a look. Natural rhythm.
That's the best version I've seen of that. I know these have been going all over social media, but that's officially my best version. I don't know, maybe we can put you on the spot, Mini. You think you could crack that challenge, maybe? The Beyonce one?
I can
I'll join you even. I'm like the worst dancer, so
I'll hold make your tablet.
Thanks a lot.
I'll
make you look good on TV. You want to do it together?
Let's
try. First dance on TV. This is okay. Content, as the youngsters call it. All right. We have a song. Let's do this. Which foot are we starting with?
So I think, because I have two left legs.
Oh, as well. Okay, snap.
So I think I'll just go like, you know.
Okay, yeah. Okay.
Should we get some music?
Yeah, music. Let's do it. We're ready. She's got all played.
Thank
okay.
You.
You
got any chance we can see the kids one more time before we make them do it one more time? can we see the kids quickly again?
I love it. I don't know. Who do you guys think did it better, myself and Mini or the kids?
Okay.
Let us know.
You guys got the leg movements wrong. Now you need to get the attitude and the arms right.
Yeah, the attitude, and it's the face. It's all about the...
Yes.
Honestly, the smiles really warm my heart. They warm everybody's that watches it. You can see clearly how contagious it is. And again, this is also another reason for all of us to maybe just have some fun, express yourself, and share it with the world. We don't always have to take life so seriously. So follow us on TikTok. We are at Expresso Show, and mention us in your videos. And who knows, you could be joining us for a TikTok segment right here live today. So don't forget to catch a new episode of Crush Unlock Your 100% tonight at 7:30 on SABC2 when you can see this beautiful soul take on one of the biggest challenges of her life. It's gonna be good. We'll see you there. It's The Crush. Unlock your 100% TV show. Catch all the excitement as we unlock Crush fans' full potential to live their dreams. Watch the show on SABC2 starting on the 1st of February every Wednesday at 7:30 p.m. Plus, you stand a chance to win your share of thousands of prizes. Simply buy any Crush and follow the pack for entry details. Crush, 100% goodness.
Thank you. I just want to activate dad mode. Okay. How does the Easter Bunny travel? By aeroplane. Stop. I'll be here all... No, I won't be here all day, just for like the next hour and a half. No, we love it. We're here to laugh. We are here to win. And one lucky viewer is about to find out if they will be laughing all the way to the bank. It's time for our second spin of the Golden Cloud Beacon Easter Wheel. And I'm going to need a massive congratulations to our latest winner, Cindy Manigo. Cindy, get in here, you worthy challenger, you. Come on, she's been doing push-ups, she's on the bag, working out, she's ready to rise to the challenge. Congratulations.
Thank you.
How are you, first of all?
Nervous.
A little bit nervous, good. I'm sorry, the 10K is gone.
I heard,
on the car, she was like, is it still there? she didn't turn around. Why? Because there is a lot more still on this wheel. There's another 2,500 rand somewhere here, and a whole lot more, and some great hampers. All right, you're gonna need to feel the vibe now, okay? And I know you are a serial competition enterer.
I am.
So family, okay? She's a winner now, okay? So let her enter whatever she wants to. All right, so it's up to you to decide how much gears you wanna give it. You're gonna have to do the spinning, okay? So that, just think about that, how much energy is gonna be needed. So let's see how Cindy won her opportunity to spin this wheel. And she said on our competition post, baking yummy cakes and cookies. Hashtag let the hunt begin. Are you the family baker?
I am.
Are you that person? Then you deserve this, okay? You've done it for everybody else. Now you deserve the treat. Cindy, are you ready to spin
the
wheel?
I'm ready.
Okay. I don't know if you want to go hard, fast, slow. You've got to feel it.
I think I'm going to go hard.
Okay, go for it, girl. 3, 2, 1, spin. That is the most aggressive wheel spin we have had. Now Easter has officially begun. Where will it end? It's a bright, fiery red. It is a number 6. Ladies and gentlemen,
250 rand.
250 rand! It's not 2,500 rand, but 250 rand. It's okay. It's something. It really is. So you can at least tell everyone who says, why do you enter these competitions? Because of this. Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
That being said, are you going to spend it on yourself?
Of course.
Are you going to spread the love?
Not for me.
Yeah, of course. You didn't even bat an eyelid there. I love it. What are the plans for Easter? What are you guys going to be getting up to?
Just staying with family, having my mom's favorite pickle fish.
Yay! Because it's going to happen. This Easter, we are ready for it. 250 rand will help you just a little bit, but do spoil yourself. You've earned it. Enter again, because I have a feeling we might see you in our competition space once again. But congratulations, Cindy.
Thank you so much.
250 rand. She gets to walk out with that. And there is always more exciting news. There is still one chance to spin and win with the Easter wheel. So don't go anywhere. You could be doing it. Do you want to give it another sacrificial spin just to feel that vibe? Whoosh. That's a Cindy spin, my friends. And don't forget, 2,500 rand.
There's no sweeter way to enjoy Easter than with homemade treats.
It's my Feel Good Breakfast Show.
Oh, yes, Nzanzi, welcome back to your Feel Good Breakfast Show. We're having such an incredible show. You're going to carry on celebrating right now. And over the past few weeks, we've been celebrating all things Afro-Italian with Fatties and Monies on Wednesdays. Now, entries for the competition are almost closed, and it's the last week to get those entries in. So hurry up, get involved. Now, to give you a much-needed dose of inspiration and some tips on how to make your entry stand out from the pack, we are joined by influencers and Fatties and Monies Italianos. We've got Tembi Siete in the building, as well as Chef Mbombi, and they are living, sleeping, and eating Ama Italiano. Because they are and will always be Italiano at heart. And clearly, dressed the part too, nailed the brief. I'm loving the look. How are we doing this morning?
We are doing great. Happy to be here. How are you?
Oh, fantastic. I'm loving the energy. I feel like I've just traveled abroad. So thank you for this experience. But let's talk about it. Fatties and Monies are doing something incredible. For the last like 100 years, they've allowed consumers to get this like sort of deep understanding and experience of Italiano through their meals, through their experiences. What is this actually mean to you? What does Afro-Italian mean to you? What is that about?
It starts with the word Afro. It's taking everything that you've experienced when you're younger, you know, seeing your mom cooking, yeah, the levers, the tin fish, the, you know, everything that you enjoyed eating and fusing it with our Fettes and Monies pasta and make it your own. And you can add a little bit of pesto to add some flavor and all these beautiful veggies. But it's everything that you've experienced that you love, that's authentic to you, enjoying eating, and just mix it up with our Fettes and Monies pasta.
Oh, that sounds...
It's beautiful. It must have soul. You know when they say soul food?
Yes.
But you add Italiano with our Fettes and Monies.
And literally, you're exuding that soul. You're like, you've... Look at this brand into a space that just resonates with Italian. Maybe I can ask you, Chef Mbombi, what makes you Fatties and Monies Italiano? I mean, we've embraced this Ama Italiano spirit and culture. What defines that within you?
Look, man, if I think about the whole Italian, you know, concept and having to grow in the township, you know, being Italian, you know, embraced different stuff, you know, from the style of how you dress. And now we're taking it to food. And to be a Fatties and Monies Afro-Italiano means that I get an opportunity to infuse African-based, you know, foods with a most important staple ingredient in, that comes from Italy.
Yeah. It's almost like we're taking some of the best flavors, cultures in the world and combining them in this sort of collaborative sense that is just, in my opinion, creating magic.
Yeah.
And honestly, like, I went to Italy. I had the blessed experience to go and
eat
there.
And it was delicious. And one thing I can definitely say is when we cook with this in our kitchens, it resonates with me and it gives me those same feelings. So the authenticity is definitely there. I've got to say that.
Yeah.
So I want to try to figure this out. Like, so Tembi, you've got this culture coming through. We've got the feeling, we've got the spice and the soul. Where to next? Like, what more can we expect from Fatties and Monies? I mean, you're really ticking all the boxes. Like, what else is there to do here?
I mean, last season, we did a whole lot of crazy, beautiful stuff. I mean, doing school activations, opening libraries for young people, and seeing them excited and just looking forward to the year. I mean, if you introduce color in the library, introduce books and fun stuff, it just says, you know, go in there and learn. So I'm looking forward to doing all these activations again. And the school tour was amazing. We have to do it again, Fatties and Monies.
Yes, please. Yeah. It's going to be a beautiful year. So much magic to be done. Yeah. Now, seeing that we are obviously speaking about Afro-Italian and we've got a chef in the building right now, maybe you can share some tips with us or maybe some of your like key ingredients that we can kind of infuse to ensure that we tick this box when it comes to nailing down this sort of Afro-Italian flavor.
Look, coming back home and infusing the whole and just bringing the whole idea into life in our kitchens, you can look towards, you know, most, you know, loved biltong. You can infuse it and use and do a biltong and pasta.
That sounds good.
You know, you look at your boerewors, your chakalaka, which is more of a relish that actually goes in well with the pasta. You can look into gizzards, Chicken livers, you can look into chicken hearts. So there's a lot of things.
I see what you're doing here. And literally, I'm salivating as you mentioned all these incredible flavors. Well, guys, thank you so much for sharing some of the magic that Fatties and Monies are doing. You're anchoring the brand, you're living the brand, you're inspiring us to also get a piece of our little flavors. So I want to say to you, Mzandi, stay tuned because up next, obviously, this beautiful man over here, Chef Mbombi, as well as Tembisi, they are going to be taking over our kitchen and we are here for it. And they're going to be showing us just how easy it can be to eat Italian with delicious and easy to make meals. So bravo, Mataliano, bravo to you. Yes, bravo. Let's head to the kitchen.
This is nothing. This is just who we are.
Ciao, Alfredo.
Hi, Gualfredo.
We date Italian.
Ciao, Florence. Chef
Nati. We drive Italian, living la dolce vita. And now you can see, that's what it is. Gadle, gadle. We're Italian.
Perfecto.
That's why I was pizza. I'm Italian. And we always eat Italian. Every day. Fettis and Monies. Bravo to you.
Well, we are hoping to inspire and spark the Ama Italiano in you with a Fatties and Monies 5 ingredients red pepper pesto and acciar pasta salad. Now, this is the kind of recipe that will set you apart in the Fatties and Monies Wednesdays competition and get your entry notice. Trust me, you want to take notes and get inspired. And here to help us, we have Chef Mbombi and, of course, brand anchor Tembi Siete in studio with us, and I'm very excited because I love this pasta. I always thought you would, I always refer to it as bow pasta, but I believe it's also butterfly pasta.
And it has its own name, it's farfalle.
Oh, farfalle.
The accent, that's not the
accent. You have to, how would you say it with the accent?
Farfalle.
There we are, of course, amazing. And what is incredible is the Fatties and Monies Bellissimo range is guaranteed quality Italian-inspired pasta. Now, Chef, this is only a 5-ingredient pasta salad that you're making. I feel like there's pressure. The less ingredients, the more there is that it needs to be executed.
Five ingredients is enough. Yeah, and I think it's pretty much straightforward, very, very simple. Mm-hmm. Something to do at home, you know, very easy, quick, back from work, and it's just that easy.
Oh, fantastic.
And what we have here is the red peppers, acha. So this is a vegetable acha, and you can use basically the mango acha and stuff like that. And this is garlic olive oil. So what you're going to do...
Yes.
We're going to let you...
Mix everything
play around here. So we're gonna mix everything around here. So we throw everything
you're
in there.
Gloves?
Yes,
oh,
baby.
The
but did you see how I took them off? You don't just. You just have to
hurry.
Yes.
Of course. We can.
Okay. Now let me
should
put
we,
them.
Should we save it here?
Somewhere
it's nice
here.
And
yeah,
safe
just
over
to keep
there.
It neat.
Now,
so I'm waiting for these.
Tembi, I need to ask you. When it comes to various pastas, are you a spicy, creamy, tomato based?
Oh, I love spicy, but not spicy hot. Just spicy with flavor and cream. As well, but my favorite is pesto.
Oh,
you can put pesto anywhere, you will never go wrong.
Oh, you can never go wrong with pesto. I agree with you. And you know what's beautiful about pesto? It's such a, like, I want to say clean ingredient because it's so simplistic and it heroes the pasta.
Absolutely.
Oh, fantastic. So, Chef, you got our pasta in?
Good stuff, yeah. I got the farfalle in. That is cooking as per packet instructions.
Yeah.
You can go back, you can go to the back of the packet and read that on how to cook it. So I'll let you do the honors.
Okay, let me
please
follow
mix
you.
Everything for us.
Okay.
Put in here.
So we roasted the peppers beforehand.
So basically we take the peppers, we roast them, drizzle them with oil, salt and pepper. Then it's either you can grill them, roast them, and you can once you've roasted them for about 15-20 minutes, you can then peel off the skins. And
I'll
blend
just
everything
measure with
in.
My spoon and not go wild with oil.
You love Brazil pesto, so it has oil.
But so not too much. Okay, you see everything in here. Come on, we don't want to be like.
Are you being a mom right now?
You have to play with oil, please. Let's be gentle with oil.
Okay, that's fine.
That's fine, right?
So, Chef, does this recipe work with green peppers and yellow peppers, or should we go with the red peppers?
Okay.
Roast it beforehand because you really get the flavor profiles coming through.
110%. So this can work with anything really, because you can basically make the pesto which is the red pepper pesto. And this is basically the same process that you do when you do the basil pesto and other pestos.
Okay.
And you can infuse the meat in there. Ah. So the bacon, well, whether it's the chicken, so on and so forth.
Or you can keep it vegetarian and just go for the pesto like we've gone today.
110%. Oh, so okay. What we've done, the pesto here, it's done, as you can see there, it is everything infused with the farfalle pasta and the red pepper basil pesto with acha.
Okay. Pasta. What gives the pesto that green feel? What veggie or what herb do they use to give it that green? Is
so,
it the same
so,
one there?
So it's a basil pesto.
Basil pesto. Okay.
110%.
That's mine.
Of which you can
I'm
make.
I'm looking forward to this one because I only know the green one. So let's see.
What is incredible about the farfalle pasta bows are that are delicious and can be used as a base for any dish, and it really is ideal for salads. And it can also be baked or tossed into a stir fry. Dish. I love what we've done here today. I mean, chef, when it comes to salads, how fond are you of salads?
I'm trying to be very, very fond of salads because, as you can see, the weight, I'm trying to...
No, but chef, this just shows you salads doesn't have to just be lettuce. It can be a yummy cold pasta salad.
Definitely. I mean, you're looking at the pasta, and more especially the fattest and monis pasta, it's very versatile.
It is.
You know, so you can make it as a main, as a side, as a salad, depending on what you throw in there. And this is actually quite healthy.
Yeah.
That now that we've used, you know, the acha pasta. So
I'm thinking now going to a braai and having that with your wors and your chops and whatever, and that being the perfect pasta to go with it. Or even if you just want to keep it dainty and have that for lunch later today.
Don't you have meat in the fridge?
We'll spice it up. What would you pair that with? What would your go-to be?
You know what? I think it's perfect alone. But if I were to pair it, yeah, I think a nice creamy chicken will also work here.
Definitely.
And you can also add a bit of cheese as well and make it warm, eat it warm, eat it cold. So it will work.
Listen, shall we? It will work. Mm. May I offer you
please,
a
ma'am.
Fork? Go
no,
for it.
No, ladies, you can't feed yourself a man's
Okay.
Okay, imagine. Chef. Oh.
Right.
Mm. Okay. Mm. I also get
flavor. See? It's definitely taking me back home. The acha, that's what we call Afro-Italian.
There we go. Tembi, thank you for joining us today. Chef Mbombi, what a great recipe that you've just shown us. And if you truly love your pasta and you're proudly Ama Italiano, then show it to us at the Fatties and Monies Wednesday Challenge. That is hashtag Fatties and Monies Wednesday Challenge. And if you want to know how to enter, well, here's how.
If you love your pasta and you're proudly Ama Italiano, then show it in the all-new hashtag Fatties and Monies Wednesday Challenge.
From the 8th to the 29th of March, four very lucky Espresso viewers stand the chance of winning your own Nutribullets, plus a Fatties and Monies hamper valued at 500 Rand. But you need to be inspired. We want you to post a picture of your favorite Afro-Italian meal, along with a product pick of the Fatties and Monies product that you used on the Espresso Facebook competition post or on your Instagram page.
So follow and tag at @Fatties_and_Monies in your entry and make sure to add hashtag Fatties and Monies Wednesdays. And the competition closes on the 29th of March. T's and C's apply. In fact, bravo, Mataliano.
Bravo to you and us.
Oh, yeah.
It's my Feel Good Breakfast Show.
Oh, yes, Mzansi, welcome back to Feel Good Breakfast Show. And let's carry on celebrating right now because we are back on the stage, still chatting to rapper, singer, and songwriter Tash A in the building. Listen, brother, your first performance, I loved it. Feeling the vibe, absolutely here for it. But let's talk about what happened last year because late last year you released a project, Pink Skies. Talk to me about it. Tell me about the inspiration behind this, man.
So Pink Skies was dropped in summer last year, in December. So Pink Skies is basically summer. The tracks that you've been hearing, like the first track, it's all about the upbeat, the pop summer vibe, yeah, and that's really what Pink Skies is. A drive along the West Coast, next to the beach, that type of vibe.
It just like moves your shoulders. I was listening to it and I'm like, what's going on here? I can't control this. Now, talking into the future now, you've just released something special. We're talking about Toxic, which has got people talking. Mm-hmm. What's the message that you're hoping to have people take from the song?
So Toxic is actually about a heartbreak situation.
Okay.
But more importantly, things like that is not really what men speak about, right?
Yeah.
So it's feelings and emotions that we usually suppress, and it leads to like bad mental health. And that's what I really was going for, you know, trying to get men to speak up about things that actually bother them. You know, because it's fine. We all go through things.
Make us feel more comfortable with that conversation and change that narrative. I absolutely love it. Well, ladies and gentlemen, without further ado, Tash A is about to perform Toxic. Brother, take it away. Stage is yours.
Got me feeling nauseous. Running like a mosh pit. Toxic. You got me feeling, yeah, you got me feeling nauseous. Running through my mind, yeah, you running like a mosh pit. Girl, yeah, you feel, yeah, you really feeling toxic. Really feeling nauseous, throw my cup of toxins. Girl, yeah, I gave you my heart and you took it. You had the key, but you missed it, running lost it. Running from my demons and I really feel exhausted. Wanting other options, throw my cup of toxins, yeah. No, it ain't an auction. Your love was a bargain. Baby, then you bought me. This will never be the same since you went and lost me. All the trust you tossed it, acting kinda frosty. Take it to the head, pop a bottle, feeling naughty. I remember days when you would write it like a Harley. My love ain't a secret, even though I show nobody. I'll say it, girl, I'm sorry. The truth won't hurt nobody. You got me fit, yeah, you got me feeling nauseous. Running through my mind, yeah, you running like a mosh pit. Girl, yeah, you feel, yeah, you really feeling toxic. Really feeling nauseous, throw my cup of toxins. Girl, yeah, I gave you my heart and you took it. You had the key, but you missed it, running lost it. Running from my demons and I really feel exhausted. Wanting other options, throw my cup of toxins. Girl, I fell in love with your soul. I didn't want to see you go. I saw you leave, slam the door, out in the cold. I feel we're running in circles when we complicate it. When we're like this, I really hate it. This really ain't the way we thought it would end, yeah. Friend, and I'm losing again. You got me feeling, yeah, you got me feeling nauseous. Running through my mind, yeah, you running like a mosh pit. Girl, yeah, you feel, yeah, you really feeling toxic. Really feeling nauseous, throw my cup of toxins. Girl, yeah, I gave you my heart and you took it. You had the key, but you're running.
touched it. Running from my demons and I really feel exhausted. One night of options, from one cup of toxins, yeah. Got me feeling nauseous, running like a mosh pit, yeah. Toxic, nauseous.
Yes, brother, that's how you slay. Absolutely love it. I'm Zanzi, don't go anywhere. We're going to obviously have one more performance from Tash A at the end of the show. But for now, though, official duties must commence. Just take it away.
Thank you, gentlemen. Let's take a look at your national headlines. Siliers Brinkhoff, that DA, is the new mayor of Tshwane after defeating Ofentse Moalosi of COPE by 112 votes to 109. The city has been leaderless since the damning allegations against COPE councillor Dr. Murunwa Makwarela, who was elected mayor in February 2023. However, it was later revealed that he had previously been declared insolvent. He subsequently challenged the declaration through an allegedly fraudulent court document. Makwarela resigned as Tshwane mayor after the allegations had surfaced. And staying with our local news, Gauteng Premier Panyaza Lesufi says 3,000 of the 6,000 young people who are being trained as wardens to patrol crime hotspots are ready to hit the streets from the 1st of May. He says they will be the ears and eyes of communities in every ward in Gauteng. Meanwhile, six police officers have been arrested in Cape Town on charges of corruption. Two sergeants and four constables aged between 31 and 42 were arrested yesterday morning by the Maitland Emergency Patrol. Now moving to news abroad, Paul Rusesabagina, hero of the film Hotel Rwanda about the 1994 Rwandan genocide, has arrived in Qatar after being released from prison in Rwanda last week. Rusesabagina, a permanent US citizen, was sentenced in September 2021 to 25 years because of his ties to a group which has an armed wing and is opposed to Rwandan President Paul Kagame. He was released after his sentence was commuted following months of negotiations between Washington and Kigali. The 68-year-old former hotelier landed in Doha on Monday, from where he will return to the US. And new clashes erupted in France yesterday between protesters and police as tens of thousands took to the streets to vent their anger against President Emmanuel Macron's pension reform, which has sparked the biggest domestic crisis of his second mandate. The day of action is the 10th since protests began in mid-January against the law, which includes raising the retirement age from 62 to 64. This development has become a major challenge to Macron, who won a second term in office last year. And bringing it closer to home, Dr. Hlena Ndume, an ophthalmologist in Namibia, born and bred there, is in the small mining town of Nsumep, is known in her home country as the Miracle Doctor. Her achievements have been just amazing. Working with the humanitarian organization SEA International, she's helped perform sight-restoring surgeries to some 38,000 people at no cost since 1994. She and her team help eradicate preventable blindness in Namibia and also in neighboring countries. As an ophthalmologist, she's internationally renowned. In the past, she scooped two major accolades, the Lions Club International Humanitarian Award and the Forbes Women Africa Social Impact Award. Of late, she was also recognized in Forbes Africa's The 50 Over 50 list of Africa's powerhouses. Of the accolades, she simply said, and I quote, "It was very humbling," and added, "My work's one of the passion. No money in the world can pay for the happiness of someone who was once blind." Dr. Ndume, we at Expresso salute you and wish you all the luck in the world. Thank you for the incredible work that you do. Well, that's where I leave your morning headlines. Let's take a final look at your sport.
We can start on a very positive note this morning when it comes to football, as South Africa have now secured a place at next year's Africa Cup of Nations finals. That was after a 2-1 away win over strong opposition in the form of Liberia. Bafana Bafana guaranteeing a top two finish in Group K alongside the already qualified Morocco, thanks to goals from Zakele Lepasa and Mihlali Mayambela. The Bafana held their nerve to get that victory and secure their place at the Nations Cup for the first time since 2019 back in Egypt. Then on to cricket. Not the most positive results from a South African perspective, as the West Indies claimed a 7-run win in that third and final T20 to win the three-match series 2-1 and maintain their record of having never lost a T20 series in South Africa. And boy, has the series provided the fireworks. So just a few days on from their record run chase, the Proteas won the toss and decided to chase yet again, which made sense, I'm sure. The visitors were scoring at a pretty good pace, but regular wickets meant that they found themselves 161 for 8 with just 4 overs left. Step in Romario Shepherd with a 44 not out and Alzari Joseph 14 not out to put on 59 for that ninth wicket, including hitting the last over for 26. And that got the side to 220 for 8. In response, Reeza Hendricks continued his stellar form. He was the mainstay for the host, scoring 83. But Joseph again stepped up, this time with the ball in hand, taking 5 for 40 as the Windies held on for that memorable win. Now, plenty to get excited about on the rugby front, certainly the shorter format of the game. The Blitzbox, they've been handed a tough draw for the prestigious Hong Kong Sevens leg taking place this coming weekend. The event, which is the 8th of the 11 in this year's calendar, sees South Africa contest Pool D alongside New Zealand, Ireland and Kenya, all hoodoo teams who have beaten the Blitzbox at some point this season. So it's going to be a trial by fire, and finishing in the top two of the pool means the Blitzbox will then play one of the top two finishers from Pool A, and that's Canada, Samoa, Fiji and Argentina. A couple of hoodoo sides in there as well. But the Hong Kong Sevens series starts officially this Friday morning for South Africa. That's SA time, 4 minutes past nine, up against Ireland, unfortunately. But set a reminder. Now, finally, we turn to athletics, and I'm sure this story is going to continue to evolve in the build-up over the next few weeks. The International Olympic Committee has recommended that Russian and Belarusian athletes are allowed to compete under a neutral flag, but have yet to make a decision on Paris 2024. So this recommendation only extends to individual athletes and not to teams. And the IOC's executive board has also told international federations and events organizers that athletes and support personnel who actively support the war in Ukraine, who are contracted to the military as well, should not be permitted to compete. But I have a feeling this one, yes, is still going to get a little more spicy, so we'll watch that space. Right now, though, the roads definitely have woken up. Let's get you to work safely. Ryle's got the latest.
Thank you so much, G. Yes, a lot of us heading on the roads this morning. We've got some news for you and obviously some tips for those that are in certain areas. And speaking of, let's look at Athlone, Cape Town. Now, there's heavy congestion on the N2 inbound at the ramp to Jake's Gravel. Now, you can expect delays and do allow for more travel time in the area. Sticking to Cape Town and Edgemead to be specific, there's also congestion on the N7 southbound, and this is at Bosmansdam Road. So maybe you should make a hot cup of coffee before hitting the roads, because it's going to be a long one. Again, in Cape Town, a truck has lost its load on the N2 inbound after Airport Approach Road. The left lane is blocked, so please, again, approach this area with caution. But leaving Cape Town now, heading to KZN and Pietermaritzburg to be specific, there's been an accident at Camperdown Interchange. Now, the road has been closed and all vehicles are being diverted. So again, please use an alternative route this morning, and anyone heading on the roads, buckle up, stay safe, and please do plan accordingly. It's time now to head from the roads to the sky and see what's happening in the latest when it comes to weather. Reporting on weather news this morning. Now, we have news of flooding in Port St. John's that has caused havoc. Now, President Cyril Ramaphosa has assured residents that there have been affected by the floods, that a contractor will commence building them temporary structures today. Now, Ramaphosa visited the Eastern Cape Town after recent floods left thousands of households destitute and three people lost their lives on Friday. Now, the floods disrupted critical infrastructure and services to water and electricity supply, as well as teaching and learning. Now, this also impacted roads as well as bridges. Now, the president said local traditional leaders had identified land where the structures would be built. Now, the government has activated a special intergovernmental committee on disaster management to provide support and relief to the affected communities. Now, teams comprising national, provincial, and local spheres of government have been assessing the damage and providing emergency support in the form of shelter, food, blankets, and other essentials. While our thoughts and condolences definitely go out to those affected by this right now, but it's time to head over from our weather news to those sunrise views. And starting off this morning's 8 o'clock edition, Ian from Durban enjoying a phenomenal view from his home whilst enjoying some delicious coffee. The pinks, the purples, the hues, they are just beautiful indeed. Thank you for sending this one in, Ian. Next up, we've got Ntswaki all the way in Pretoria showing off a different perspective, an artsy shot, and I absolutely love it. The sun peeking through the flowers. He's got foreground. He's got a blurred out background. Lots of light and power. I love it. Len Smith coming through next up, and this one was standing outside. He looked up and saw a beautiful view of the mountain, and what a stunning view it was. And this one from Plumstead, I mean, look at that majestic light shining on it. I love it. And then Janine is showing off a perfect photo. Now, this looks like a piece of art. The mountains to the ocean, it's just an absolutely magical sunrise. I mean, this is life. I don't know what holiday destination this is. Oh, it's Plet, I think. And what a beautiful shot indeed. Again, Mzanzi, thank you for sending all these incredible pictures in. Keep sharing them on 063-408-8863. And speaking of the rest of the country, let's take a look at our temperatures one last time. Starting off in Polokwane, the day starting at a low of 14 up to a high of 28 degrees. Mbombela sees the day starting at 18 up to 34. Pretoria, 14 up to a high of 26. And Johannesburg, starting at 14, moving up to a high of 24. 4 degrees Celsius. Over to Mahikeng now, where the day starts at a low of 13 up to 27 degrees. Klerksdorp sees the day starting at 14 up to 27. Kimberley, 7 is your low up to a high of 29 degrees. And Bloemfontein starting the day at 6 up to a high of 25 degrees. Moving around the coast now and over to Richards Bay, you can expect some rainfall on your side of town, 19 up to a high of 28 degrees. Pietermaritzburg, much the same with the rain, 14 up to 26 degrees. Durban, similar conditions from 20 up to 25. And Mthatha, 12 is your low up to a high of 24 with some rainfall expected in your side of town. Carrying on around the coast now and moving over to East London, 13 is your low up to a high of 23 degrees. Craddock sees the day starting at 7 up to 23. GQ Berga sees the day starting at 14 up to 22. A little bit of wind coming through that side of the world. And George, you can expect rain from 12 being your low up to a high of 18 degrees. Cape Town, the mother city, 14 all the way up to 19 degrees. Worcester sees the day starting at 7 up to 22. Sutherland, the chilly 3 degrees to start the day, moving up to only 19. And Upington, 11 is your start of the day, taking up to a high of 29 degrees. Again, Mzanzi, thank you for the incredible pictures. Thank you for lightening and brightening up our day, and we absolutely love to see it.
Don't go anywhere, South Africa, because when we come back, so it's more of the culinary hotline
thing. This is all over the
with Zoe Brown. She's busy sleeping, but we'll wake her up during the ad break. Don't go anywhere.
Hey, what's that?
This is Octifex, a new accessible platform to trade Forex on global markets.
Cool. What's a Forex?
It's short for foreign exchange, trading currencies.
Buy low, sell high. Score points, right?
Exactly.
What's leverage?
It's like you got cool friends. They vouch for you, and you can trade it big.
Precisely.
So basically, it's an app where you learn and trade, and it's safe, and it looks good.
That about sums it up here. Octifex, trading made clear.
It's my Feel Good Breakfast Show.
Welcome back to the last installment of the Culinary Hotline Bling.
Ting, ting, ting!
We're really having a blast in the studio today.
Ah.
Yeah, and I feel like it's also the fact that the bed is freely available this morning.
That sounds weird.
No. It is. But I mean, I can't see Ryle. I can't see Graham. I have no idea where they are. And I've got a sneaky suspicion.
They're taking a nap.
They're taking a nap.
A teeny tiny nap.
I mean, they look so cute. Okay. You've got a breakfast suggestion. This is your favorite breakfast.
My favorite breakfast has to be chicken livers. Now, this is obviously a real treat because I don't get breakfast in bed Monday to Friday because of the early mornings that we have. But when you do get that option, a chicken livers with crispy dipping bread because it's all about the sauce. Ooh, yummy.
This is the breakfast of champions.
Yes.
I love chicken livers, especially for breakfast like you do too. Let's get started. So, I like the fact that you're frying your chicken livers off separately to the sauce that you make, because that's the way you should always do it. You get like nice color in your livers, and the only way to do that is to fry it off separately. So let's start off with the chicken livers. Okay.
Got a little bit of olive oil.
Okay, and butter. Chicken livers need butter.
It's I always thought it was a bit taboo to add butter and olive oil.
The thing about adding the oil and the butter is that the oil just stops the butter from burning too much, because with chicken livers, another thing you want is a high heat. You want to go like smoking hot, high heat. And you can see our pan smoking. Mm. You want that to happen. So when butter gets melted into the oil, I also like, I say, you first get the butter screaming and then it simmers down and it's like, aha, that's when you know you're ready. So when the butter just starts to brown, it's called a bournazette. All the French out there coming for me. It's basically a brown butter. Then you can see it now, brown butter. In we go with our livers. Give it to me.
And livers is not something you need to overcook.
No, not at all. So get that heat going. Give it a little shimmy, shimmy. Give it a little top. Get a little flame going.
Look at them flames in there.
There we go. It's breakfast. You got to start the day off on a flaming note, okay? Once that just gets color, it's done. We do have a voice note, though, from Colleen. Do you want to hear it?
Let's listen to it. Morning, Colleen.
Morning, Expresso family. Hope you're all well. Thank you for a lovely program. Please, can Chef Clem just explain to me the technique of doing poached eggs? I don't seem to get it right. I do put vinegar in the water when I boil it, but it still isn't right. Okay. If you can just explain the technique, I would really appreciate it. Thanks very much. This is Colleen from Durban. Bye.
Thank you, Colleen. You know what? A poached egg goes well with chicken livers. Mm-hmm. I've never been able to make a poached egg. I always order them from the restaurant. But how can we help Colleen out? What's the best way to go about making poached eggs?
So the most important thing when you're making poached eggs is that your eggs have to be fresh. The protein, which is the white of the egg, starts to deteriorate, becomes runny the longer you keep it on shelf or in the fridge. The fresher the egg, the tighter the proteins, and that's the shape you want. You want it to hold together. So it's always going to kind of fail if you have eggs that are a little older than normal. So work with the freshest eggs you have. Then the water is also very important. You don't want it to be rumbling and boiling. You want a few bubbles to make it to the surface, okay? Then a little bit of vinegar or a little bit of lemon juice, like you're doing, to the water. Crack your egg into a teacup first, and then gently drop that egg into the water. You don't want it to splash. And again, you also don't want the water to be rumbling, because that rumbling is going to disturb
the egg. Go everywhere.
Yeah. Fresh eggs, just simmering water. I like the fact you're using the vinegar, and that you should be good with that. Don't try and poach four eggs at one time. Work with one first.
Okay.
Get the technique right, and that's when you can step up to doing like three or four eggs at a time.
And once it's in the water, you leave it. You don't fiddle with it.
You don't fiddle with it. You let it do its thing. You'll see that it'll just gradually start cooking, and it will go from clear to opaque. That's what you want. If your water's too high, you'll also find that the outside might be cooked and the inside's not.
Still. And I mean, that's not a soft egg. That's an uncooked egg.
Chicken liver is going into our delicious sauce, and I just messed, but I'm going to show you how we made the sauce.
Yes.
Onions go into a pan, and you want to take your time with this. This part, you want to simmer your onions for about 20 minutes, bring out 20 minutes.
Really?
Bring out the natural sugars in the onions, okay?
And you want to do that on a low heat.
Low. So don't do as I do as I say.
Okay.
So on a low heat, you're going to go for about 20 minutes.
We are pressed for time here.
Okay, got it. A little bit of butter going in.
No,
little
no,
bit
I'm
of
just
salt.
Saying in general, we are pressed for time. Don't worry. I'm just saying we don't have 20 minutes to simmer onions.
I was going
to
do it in like 30 seconds now. But yes, a little bit of salt goes on there. That helps draw out the moisture in the onions and soften them. To that, we're going to add, and I love this.
Chili.
Chili in the morning. Yes,
gives
absolutely.
You that kick you need. Plus, we're going with Indian-style tomatoes, and this which already has a bite in it.
And again, this is your recipe, and I'm really impressed with the hacks that you have. Using the Indian-style tomatoes instead of the normal tin tomatoes is a great way to bulk up flavor, and it's already been seasoned. It's already got elements in there that's going to give you a delicious flavor dimension. Great one there, Zoe.
Thank you. And you know what? We do add a little bit of cream just to bring it back down to earth. We also don't want it to be too spicy so early in the morning. Although I love a good spice with my chicken livers.
Yes, absolutely. This sauce as it is right here would be amazing with so many things.
Mm.
You could even modify this to be a curry. You could actually like...
add boerewors roll in there, like a smurki.
Yes, yes. Okay, so the cream, like you said...
add that to the boerewors roll, not the other way around.
Other way around. I know, I get you, I get you. Little bit of the cream going in, that's going to come together, that's going to reduce beautifully. And again, this recipe by Zoe Brown, you could actually make the sauce ahead of time, make it in a big batch, freeze this, because this is only going to get better and better and better the longer it sits. You add your chicken livers, you serve that with some garlic bread. Let me get my...
Yes! Should I cut it? I'm going to cut the bread.
Sure, you do that. Can I get your plate in the center, please?
Of the table.
There we go. The pan's hot. There we go. Really hot. If you have one of those beautiful little...
I would serve it in a bowl.
I was going to say, little bowl or little individual cast iron pans, that's also quite cute.
Serve it in a bowl. You
serve
want
it in a bowl.
Dipping element. This
I
is a massive
love
portion.
It.
You're very generous.
This is... Well, I thought that Ryle and Graham were going to be sharing a plate in the bed. Look at this. Look at this. Show me the garnish. Show me the garnish.
Just a little.
You want to deliver it to the guys?
Yeah, should I go deliver it to
deliver
them?
Deliver it to them,
making
yeah.
It, but this was my breakfast.
You have
do,
it.
Do
Sorry.
I have to share it?
No, you don't have to. Sorry, Ryle. Sorry, Graham. They're sleeping anyway, so what they don't know won't hurt them. Yeah. Oh, look at them.
So this is my breakfast. May I taste my own breakfast?
Please do.
I just heard the social media team say, what, we need a photo.
I'll get you
taste,
a photo.
I'll taste just the chicken livers because Chef Clem made it fresh.
Okay. Don't forget to get this recipe.
Beautiful in color.
Zoe Brown's chicken livers with delicious smoochy on expressoshow.com. Mm. Make the recipe, tag Zoe, tag Espresso, tag me, tag Ral, tag Graham, tag your granny.
Thank
just
you, Clem.
Make the recipe.
Thank
How
you.
How good is it?
It's really good, I love it.
Makes me happy. Next week, we'll be back with more Culinary Hotline. We want to know if there's anything you want to see us do on the show, your favorite dishes, let us know on our social pages, please. It's been an amazing Culinary Hotline bling. Let's do it nice and loud so we can wake the guys up. It's a Culinary Hotline bling! Ting, ting, ting!
Ting.
Whenever you have something really cold, and then you get this short, sharp kind of sensation, that's sensitivity. It can get worse. The problem is not going to go away by itself. I always recommend Sensodyne. It's specially designed to care for their sensitive teeth. And I've had people coming back to me saying it's made a difference. It works.
Join the bank that's best for your loan. Choose up to 200 Rand cash back monthly with a personal loan. Apply for a personal loan and a savvy account today. Nedbank, see money differently.
It's my feel-good breakfast show.
Welcome back, your beauty. Thank you so much for keeping it locked to your feel-good breakfast show. Yes, we've had our 20 winks, 15 winks, I don't know how much that was. I feel refreshed and ready.
Comfortable.
You missed out on breakfast, I'm just saying.
I know, man, we dodged something major there. Well, you might want to dodge this particular bullet because it's going to be a difficult one. We're going to set a scenario for you guys as part of our Money Matters discussion this morning. And yes, we are talking money and love, two things that we generally do love the most. But what happens when you combine the two and that conversation starts drifting, especially on a first date? So I'm gonna put a scenario to you guys so you can give me a would you rather scenario outcome. All right, so here's the scenario, gang. You're on the first date, and out of nowhere, they ask how much you earn.
You're hectic.
I know, it's full on, eh?
Hectic.
Okay, do you, A, yes, tell them, it's no biggie. B, no, that's too personal. Also, major red flag. I don't even know if I need to ask you these questions. Zoe, I think you like...
All the way. That is a very personal question. It's not something you discuss on the very first date. If someone volunteers that information, to me, it's also a bit of a turnoff. Why are you bragging about
that? You should be able to kind of pick up where they're at in their station of life, how they roll.
Taking into account what restaurant you may be at for the
first date. Yeah, exactly.
But I think it's definitely a red flag. For me, it's going to detract from this person showing an interest in me as a human being, and they're more concerned potentially with my financial
situation.
Exactly. That's like, whoa, red flag. Like, who are you here for? Like, does the me even matter? Or is it just about the money?
Oh, shame.
You know what I mean? Like, I'm also important.
You are important, Raul. You matter. Well, let's see what the people had to say.
Yeah.
Let's look on social media. First up, we have Velma says, awesome Wednesday to all. B, there's no way on a first date you're already asking such a personal question. Gary Oldcamp says, gold alert. It's actually happened before. As soon as they see my car, the phone's out, and they start taking selfies, then they ask what I do for a living. I should start using my bucky when I go on dates.
Gary's the best, man.
I'd just like to send a crew to follow you around.
Just a day in the life of the orca. I love it.
There are more comments that came through. We have Siobhan saying, good morning, team. B, it's a big red flag, definitely. It should never be asked on the first date unless they're with the person for money.
Oh, yeah.
And then Sandra says, definitely B. I was once asked that question, and he thought I will be, I will be his personal ATM. And no, of course not. I did not reveal my salary. He just assumed.
Okay, so there's like some dating advice here. Don't ask that question maybe as well.
Especially if you're walking down a street and you're weighing up restaurants and then they ask, how much do you earn? They're like, okay, no, we'll go somewhere else. That might be a little bit of a red flag here as well. I think, Zoe, we've given you a tough question to really absorb here. So we're going to let you go to the kitchen and continue to think of...
Give someone money.
Yes!
Let's flip the script completely. We love that, man. But financials, it's always going to be a difficult one.
It is, man. It's a tricky thing, and navigating finances in a new relationship especially can be even trickier. Sure. But if they are the one, then you can invite them to join family banking. And that's on the Nedbank Money app, and they will enjoy the benefits of saving 50% on their banking fees, and that'll definitely sweep them off their feet. So to sign up, you can visit the Nedbank Money app, and nothing else but good luck is being wished upon you and maybe all your lovers too.
Oh, thank you, gentlemen. Well, listen, we can't start off our Wheel of Win without a little joke. So what do you call a mischievous egg? A practical yoker. I'll take that. Thank you very, very much. Well, it's time for us to make someone else a winner. Of course, we have our Golden Cloud and Beacon Wheel, and this is where we find out when we spin how much you can win. Now, we have Nkola Hleng on the line. Good morning.
Morning.
How are you feeling today?
I'm feeling good because it's my birthday. Thank you so much for asking.
Oh, fantastic. I like you, and I hope you win a lot of money. Well, before we get to spinning the wheel, this is what you said on social media to get you this far. You know it's Easter when you enjoy at Golden Cloud SA chocolate cake and Beacon Treats. Hashtag let the hunt begin. Well, listen, let's make you a winner. Is there a particular wedge you would like to win? Keep in mind, number one is taken as well as number six. Should you land on any of those squares that have wedges that have a white patch, you will not win the cash prize, but you'll still walk away with a hamper. So, which one are you feeling?
I'm feeling number seven.
Number seven. Let's see if you can get lucky number seven. Okay, Nkalukhle, okay. Are you ready for me to spin the wheel?
I am ready.
Okay, I need you to count me down.
Three, two, one.
And spin.
Spin the wheel.
There we go. What numbers are gonna be? Can it be number seven? Oh, you know what? You don't win what was behind number six, but you still walk away with a hamper. And of course, you know the hamper is going to be lots of goodies for Easter. So how do you feel?
I'm feeling great.
Oh, we are so happy for you.
I'm feeling so great.
And
yes,
any special...
My birthday.
Oh, and are there any special Easter traditions that you do with the family?
We normally chill together, have some bright, good time, and that's it, not much.
Oh, and do you have a favorite of your Beacon Easter treats?
Yes, I love marshmallow eggs.
Oh, they are the best. I'm hoping those will be in your hamper, but congratulations, you're not walking away empty-handed, and that is how easy it is. And Golden Cloud and Beacon, they are giving another three lucky viewers the chance to win up to 10,000 Rand in our Easter Wheel Spin live on the show, and this is live on air. Now, you simply need to reply to the competition post that is on our Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram pages and answer this very easy question. Describe your ultimate Easter egg hunt with Beacon Treats and Golden Cloud. Don't forget to hashtag let the hunt begin. The entries close at 9 a.m. tomorrow, so get those entries in, and there are T's and C's that can be found on our website, expressoshow.com.
There's no sweeter way to enjoy Easter than with homemade treats.
Are you a rising star in the kitchen, ready to bake it till you make it? Then enter the new season of Tastemaster SA, brought to you by tried and trusted Royal Baking Powder on SABC2, where you could win 50,000 rands worth of prizes and become a baking legend. Visit thetastemaster.co.za. Share a video about yourself and why you love baking with Royal Baking Powder. Entries close on 23 April. T's and C's apply.
It's my feel-good breakfast show.
Oh, yes, the feel-good continues right here, right now. And we're talking about something that everybody can get excited for. We're going camping! Yes, and camping in South Africa is definitely the best thing that you could possibly do. But if you don't know where to start when your packing list is not just the essentials, like a toothbrush, well, then listen up.
Well, we have a list for you with all the must-haves for a great Easter outdoor. And you can say goodbye to high prices with Game's Easter La Vista deals.
Easter La Vista. All right, so if you're testing the camping waters and going on short camping trips, then the Camp Master Dome tent, which is only 799 Rand, is perfect for any beginner. Now, on top of this, here's a great hack that you maybe want to think about. Use a breathable ground sheet to keep most of the dirt out. So don't take the dirt into the tent with you. Get it out before. Perfect tip. You're going to like that one.
That's a good tip. And then nothing makes a camping trip as unpleasant as waking up with a stiff back or a sore neck. Invest in an air mattress. For $3.99, this queen air bed and pillows will have you looking for any excuse to go camping again. And here's a hack for you. Don't forget to pack the pump, because blowing up a mattress is not for the faint of heart.
It'll take you the whole day. Definitely. Definitely. Now listen up. When it comes to sleeping bags, we all want that comfort. So you can purchase one that is within your budget and, of course, temperature range too. So here's an option for you. For 499 Rand, the Sleeping Bag Explorer will up your comfort levels this camping season. And if you've got a partner to join you along, then how cool is this hack? You can share your sleeping bag with your significant other by simply getting two of the same sleeping bags, and then you can zip them together. How cool is that?
That is cool. Then you have a big pocket.
Yeah.
A big one.
That's awesome.
There we go.
Lots of warmth.
Well, listen, this one you do want to have. You can get a gas stove that still works for the number of people you're catering for. Mm. Small hiking stoves can be great for up to three people, like this Kadak budget pack for only 849 Rand. And here's a hack for you. Don't go without any good coffee while camping, which means packing a kettle to boil your water is essential. Mm,
the essentials here to serve you, Mzansi. All you got to do now is plan that camping trip, because what else do you need, right? So camping gives us the privilege of nights closer to nature. And as with many outdoor adventures, what you pack makes a difference to the quality of your experiences. So make sure you visit your nearest game store to stock up on your camping essentials today and capitalize on Mzansi's magic.
Thank you so much, guys. Well, don't head out camping just yet. Let's keep it indoors and explore the Italian in all of us, because we really have been embracing it, and we are here for the food. And this next recipe is going to be a crowd pleaser, and it really does flip the script. So obviously, being a Pasta Wednesday, we've got to try our hand at being as creative as possible, and I can only do this surrounded by the most exquisite people, and of course, inspired by the most exquisite home chefs. So we've got Bhavna Singh on the line right now. Bhavna Singh on the line right now. And she entered with a pickled fish and homemade chakalaka sauce and homemade chakalaka pasta. Bhavna, you're on the line right now. Are you there?
Yes, hi, how are you?
Oh, very good. Sorry for butchering your name. Now that you've got your 5 minutes of fame, we want to make sure that the people know who you are, because you've done something special. We are loving Pasta Wednesdays. What inspired your dish?
What inspired my dish was actually Easter time, and it's pickled fish, and pickled fish is something that we all celebrate with during Easter. And it's actually a very healthy dish as well. And our family love Sacchi Bodhi's pasta. So we're actually inspired by that.
I love it. I love the fact that the kids are fighting for the food right now. They're like, Mom, give us the food. We want our pasta. Congratulations. I've got to say, well done. You are the your dish especially is the Afro-Italian at its finest, and you've won yourself a brand new NutriBullet and a Fatty Simone's hamper. Congratulations!
And Fatty Simone, thank you so much.
Oh, congratulations. Keep inspiring us with your creativity. Well done. We're going to do our best now to recreate our version of it so you can watch and laugh at home, and hopefully it'll be as delicious as yours. But have the most blessed time with your family. Well done.
Thank you so much.
Well, if you guys want to be an Ami Italiano and stand a chance to walk away with that brand new NutriBullet and your own Fatty Simone's hamper worth $500, but aren't quite sure what dish to make, what will set you apart from the rest, well, listen up. We've got the incomparable Chef Mbombi and the even more incomparable Tembi Siete joining us in our kitchen. I'm sorry, buddy. You are beautiful, but it's...
It's fine.
It's Tim. It's
okay. Come on. It's my girl.
So what we're doing, guys, we're pushing the boats out here a little bit, this one. It's got a bit of cheese. We've got some pilchards. And, of course, we've got our bellissimo ridged macaroni, which can hold a lot of sauce. Mm-hmm. Chef, how are you wrapping your head around this one? This is interesting, guy.
So this is a Fatty Simone's 5 ingredients pilchard bake, which is particularly very, very simple, you know. And I'll just run you through what we have here. You know, the most loved tin fish.
Yes.
Yeah. You know, it's one of the best value proteins in the world.
Look, man.
It really is.
There's stories behind
this. Behind,
I'm sure everyone has a story behind this.
Beautiful stories behind. No.
So, exactly. Here we have a tomato based sauce. We have a white sauce. Then we have the macaroni. We have cheese. So just to, you'll help me layer everything.
Definitely.
Right. I'm doing absolutely nothing except tasting.
That's
my job. That's my job.
So, it's fine. I'll start on my side. So okay. I'll pour the sauce in here.
I love the sound of that.
And that's looking like quite a creamy tomato sauce.
110%. So this has to simmer for about 2 minutes because this is already steamed.
Yeah. Okay. So it's ready.
So it doesn't have to literally take time.
Okay.
Isn't the joy here with pilchards? You're getting the flavor. They've already been cured in such a delicious, beautiful tomato sauce. I think you forget that you're winning. I mean, you could just eat it out of the tin and it would be delicious.
No, you can't do that.
You can do it. But not today, not on a Pasta
not today.
Wednesday.
No.
Do you take out the bones?
I do. Honestly, I do.
Really?
Yes, I put in the plate or just something like this and just separate it and make
it's
nice
bougie.
And soft. Yeah.
It's bougie.
I don't.
You don't?
No.
So you, everything's off.
It's
yeah.
extra
everything.
Nutrients, extra texture.
Uh-huh. I eat everything.
Yeah.
Okay. You're not alone in this kitchen.
And
Chef,
what's next after this one?
Kitchen.
So, obviously, we already have our pasta cooked.
Okay.
I think everyone at home can... go back, refer to the back of the packet and how to cook the pasta into the water. Mm-hmm. Then, but I'll give you the honors.
Please do. So you
everything.
Direct me.
So basically, we have to start with the white sauce.
Sauce.
Layer it on the.
All right.
Then.
Can you do that now?
The pasta feels like proper construction.
Not a lot.
Just not a lot. Bit. Is this enough?
Yeah, that's fine.
Okay. Perfect. Then layer it.
It's your
out,
plate.
Make it neat.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Ha, look, professional.
And Tammy, you know, like, everyone has, especially when it comes to Afro-Italian, we have our way. Everyone likes their flavors. You know what your family and your friends like. And
absolutely.
The joy here is that you can do it just for you.
Just for you. Okay,
sure.
What's next?
So, we can take the pasta.
Pasta?
What I'm loving about this macaroni, look at the size.
Whoa, okay.
Look at where the sauce will be able to go
enough,
inside
right?
that.
Yeah.
Okay.
Then we can add our pilchard sauce on top.
All right, so as we add our super protein here, let's talk about this delicious pasta. Yeah. And I'm going to say it again, always choose Fatty Simone's for premium pasta quality and versatility, as we are proving that it will allow you to have fun and get creative in the kitchen. That's the whole point. And create new pasta dishes by using chopped up vegetables, cheese, always the cheese, and any kind of sauce or protein. And you can also serve what is left over for lunch the next day, if there is anything left over. But
Graham,
I don't think there
I
is.
Always wanted to do this.
Go for it. She's a cheese bae.
Always.
For the gram, baby.
For the gram.
Oh,
but is it enough,
good.
Or you want more?
Hey. It's your plate.
It's my
plate.
Okay, we love cheese.
That,
we love cheese.
And this is chef's approach. I love the fact that you've got like culture resting on your shoulders. You've got chef school resting on your shoulders. You've probably got some old chef resting on your shoulders, but it's your plate.
It's okay. Your plate.
You cook your way, hey?
Yeah, no, for sure.
That's already the whole point. Mm-hmm. And then how do we finish this guy off?
So we pop this into the oven, oven bake it just to caramelize the, and just to for the cheese to melt and to get the crisp on the cheese, to brown it and to...
I'm going to dish up a little for our extra special guest this morning because she has earned the right.
Oh, it looks great.
It's amazing.
And I love the crispy feeling, that sound.
Because you want a bit of texture.
Yes.
You want a little bit of everything. My dear, I suppose this is a new thing in all the many years that we've known each other. I've never cooked you breakfast, so...
Oh, thank you, Graham.
And I didn't cook this either.
It has been a journey in the half, but beautiful one, hey?
And this is the joy of having fun. I know we make light of, like, there are just so many cool crossover connections with South Africa and Italian love of passion of food, of life. Check in the face. And?
Yeah, vaya bra.
Really?
Yeah, hamba. Imnandi.
And she's...
It's beautiful.
Yeah, good
duke. Yeah, good duke.
And she's got that kind of face that can't lie, eh? Even if she wanted to on air, she's too sweet. She wouldn't be able to do it. Absolutely lovely. Maybe, Chef, I can ask you, because you've just nailed this. Every time you've kind of South Africanized something that would seem quite Italian, what's your go-to? How do you go about kind of putting together things like this when you are getting a bit more creative?
Look, it's there's a very thin line.
Yeah.
As you know, innovation is a very thin line because you'll have to deal with people's palates.
Yeah.
And how do you basically, you know, bring a balance to what is our own and what's favored in Italy, which is the pasta. But I think just to keep it simple, I always keep it simple in the kitchen. We saw today 5 ingredients, and you just don't overcomplicate it, just make it easy, and there you go.
That being said, Tembi, what pasta are you going to make for dinner tonight?
Oh, my, you know what? Wednesday. It's funny that earlier I mentioned tin fish, and I was surprised that that's what you'll be making now. And like, okay, I'm on the right track. I love it. I'm going to give it a try. I'll do this one tonight because it's easy.
And it'll be
simple and it's yummy, and it takes you back home, you know?
I absolutely love it.
Graham, it's always a pleasure.
Oh, we love having you guys here. Thank you so much for making it simple and making it so much fun. So hopefully you guys have bought into that and are going to push the boat out and get creative. And if you truly love your pasta as much as we do and you're proudly Italiano, then it's your chance to prove it in the hashtag Fatties and Monies Wednesday Challenge. And this is how you do it.
If you love your pasta and you're proudly Italiano, then show it in the all-new hashtag Fatties and Monies Wednesday Challenge.
From the 8th to the 29th of March, 4 very lucky Espresso viewers stand the chance of winning your own Nutribullets, plus a Fatties and Monies hamper valued at 500 Rand. But you need to be inspired. We want you to post a picture of your favorite Afro-Italian meal, along with a product pick of the Fatties and Monies product that you used on the Espresso Facebook competition post or on your Instagram page.
So follow and tag at @Fatties_and_Monies in your entry and make sure to add hashtag Fatties and Monies Wednesdays. And the competition closes on the 29th of March. T's and C's apply. In fact, bravo, Mataliano.
Bravo to you and us.
Oh, yeah.
It's my feel-good breakfast show.
Yes, you beautiful souls, welcome back to your feel-good breakfast show. And what an incredible show. We've been having so much fun, cooking up so many good meals, man. I'm
really
loving it.
Can I just say one thing that I've got to get off my chest? Because everyone's talking about filling up stadiums. So I was there when Tembi and co filled up stadiums back in the day. People have been filling up stadiums in South Africa for a while now. Tembi Siete has been one of them. Okay, I'm just going to get it off my chest. But right now, yes, we are talking about breakfast in bed, something that we've had the most amazing breakfast in bed this morning.
Well, apart from my real bed, this bed has been phenomenal. I'm going to sleep in the studio from now on because
Thank you, baby. I had a full English breakfast for the first time with bread pudding and everything.
Very nice. So let's see what the rest Zanzi has to say. Henny or Jerry Ellis says, good morning, family. I think it was leftover Christmas trifle on Boxing Day.
Fair game.
Yum.
Fair game.
Yeah,
Boxing Day is only leftovers, isn't
it's leftover day, actually.
Gwyneth Janssen saying, good morning, all. Well, all I can say is you're setting us up for something here. Leftover masala steak Gatsby with Coke, knickknacks, chocolate, and to balance it all out.
A
cup of coffee. Lol. The best.
That is like a pure indulgence. Is that even
We have a winner.
We have a winner, ladies and gentlemen. You just clocked breakfast all together. Oh, my goodness. Adeline Governor's definitely not going to be that good, but she says, good morning, guys. It was chicken tikka. Okay.
I'll take that.
Ooh, listen to this. Palesa Mashego says, good morning, family. It was Maguinha, Acha, and rooibos tea. Whoa.
Palesa, I like the rooibos tea to balance things out, to make it sound breakfasty in just a little bit of a way. I love it, man. We've got some winners there. Clearly, y'all are crazy just like us. Keep it coming, man. Whatever you do today, make sure you do have breakfast in bed and make sure it's a little bit silly.
Yeah, you definitely earned it. And we're going to carry on celebrating right now. Check this out. Ooh, can't wait.
Oh, well, we only have a few minutes left, so we're going to be chatting to rapper, singer, and songwriter Tash A. Now, he's been with us all morning, and before he wraps up the show, I think it's quite cool that we just get to know you even a little bit better. When it comes to the songwriting process for you, when do you find your most creative time? Like early mornings, late nights, during the day?
I do most of my recording at night, so I would say late night, but like the whole creative process for me is just journaling. So at any time of the day, if I feel like I need to write something, that's when I do.
You keep notes of it. You keep notes of it all. And, I mean, we've been talking about breakfast all morning. Are you a big breakfast person, or are you one of those individuals that skip it because you're a night owl?
Yeah, basically. I'm usually asleep during breakfast time. I stop my day at lunch.
Amazing, amazing. Well, listen, we are so excited. I know you've got quite a few cool projects coming up. Mm-hmm. Anyone in particular you would love to collaborate with?
Like an artist?
Yes.
I think I'd like to work with Youngster CPT. You know, he's doing some amazing things for Cape Town. There's a lot of other Cape Town artists as well. But yeah, I'll give props to Youngster at this point.
Amazing. Now, you're going to perform your track, Summer Heat. Can you tell us a little bit about this one?
Okay, so Summer Heat is actually the ideal summer experience, you know, driving along the West Coast, you know, with your partner on the left side. I make reference to that. So, you know, just watching the sunset, vibing.
Amazing. Well, listen, Tash Shea is on your Feel Good Breakfast show, and here he is with his track, Summer Heat.
Everything I said, I regret it like a throwback. I'm moving where we ever been, she's a Kodak. We've been steady hitting in the nail, it's a throwback. Can't stop till I hit a number one. Keeping it 100, yeah, you know this ain't fun. Second guessing everything, my time is gonna come. Steady repping everything I said like it's the one. You make it hard to leave, I thought I'd let you know. You feel like summer heat, I feel like I sunk cold. Swear on the coast with me, you know the way we roll. Side, on the west side, on my left side, that's the best side. I thought you said we could ride, ride, ride. You disappear like the stars in the sky. I might crash, I need you to drive. I'm with a lit and I can't feel my face. Running too fast, wanna give you a taste, yeah. I'm a super breath,
road, swerving alongside, along the west side, on my left side, that's the best side.
Yes, that is! My brother, please take a bow. What a pleasure having you here. You can come join us in the bed when you're ready to have a little snooze.
Come chill out.
We're going to send him off to perform in just a moment. It's been such a pleasure having you here. Where are you going to be performing next, my brother?
My next performance will be at Selective Live Studios. I think that's in Woodstock. And yeah, that'll be in May. Now I'm taking a bit of a break to capture myself, you know, gain some more experience and inspiration. So yeah.
And we're going to need you to inspire us again. So head over to that mic, my friend. You're going to close us out with one more performance.
So. Okay.
We love you guys so, so much. Thank you for joining us for this beautiful Wednesday morning. Hopefully you are still in bed and you're going to stay in bed for the rest of today. But if you're going to get that breakfast in bed menu sorted, we want to see all of the pictures. But here is how you go into a midweek day. Let's take it away with one more performance, my brother. The stage is yours. Enjoy.
Got me feeling nauseous, yeah. Running like a mosh pit, yeah. Toxic. You got me feeling, yeah, you got me feeling nauseous. Running through my mind, yeah, you're running like a mosh pit. Girl, yeah, you feel, yeah, you really feeling toxic. Really feeling nauseous, throw my cup of toxins. Girl, yeah, I gave you my heart and you took it. You had the key, but you missed the run and lost it. Running from my demons and I really feel exhausted. Wanting all the options, fill my cup with toxins, yeah. No, it ain't an option, your love was a bargain. Baby, then you bought me. This will never be the same since you went and lost me. All the trust you tossed it, acting kinda frosty. Take it to the head, pop a bottle, feeling naughty. I remember days when you would ride it like a Harley. My love ain't a secret even though I show nobody. I'll say it, girl, I'm sorry, the truth won't hurt nobody. You got me feeling, yeah, you got me feeling nauseous. Running through my mind, yeah, you running like a mosh pit. Girl, yeah, you feel, yeah, you really feeling toxic. Really feeling nauseous, throw my cup of toxins. Girl, yeah, I gave you my heart and you took it. You had the key, but you missed the run and lost it. Running from my demons and I really feel exhausted. Wanting other options, throw my cup of toxins. I fell in love with your soul. I didn't want to see you go.
Better food choices never tasted so good, nor were they ever so easy as the range of healthy living options. Made with love by Clover.
Never feel good.